Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're all doing well. It's time for Dune Spice Wars, round two. And today we're going to be playing the Fremen. So I got a chance to play them for a couple minutes last night, and I certainly had quite a bit of fun. But we will be finishing a full playthrough today. So those streams usually end up being around 4 hours, give or take, and I think we can get through the entire campaign. Are you ready for the desert power? Yes. Yes, I am. And they have some pretty cool mechanics. So let's break it down. Here we go. Here are the Fremen. Military units suffer minus 30% daily supply drain, so this makes them very good at going long distances from their main base. You can also take a little bit more of a risk going through deep deserts, which drain your supplies quicker if you want to, but what I found this to be really useful for is actually going around and just perpetually either raiding or liberating villages, because the Fremen actually have a unique difficulty. A unique ability where when they liberate villages after having researched a certain technology, they actually get a ton of money. So for the Fremen, you can play like a liberator role, which is I think how I'm going to be playing today. It's really fun. You just kind of expand your own little empire and then you go around and just liberate all these villages from the Atreides and the Harkonnen and the smugglers, and you're freeing these villages, which is very flavorful for the Fremen, and you're also of course getting rewarded for it, which is cool. Which is very, very cool indeed. On top of that, you get to ride sandworms. Sandworms are pretty good. And the reason why is they can appear anywhere on the map. So for example, if you're playing like Atreides or Harkonnen or smugglers, you can only fly in places where you have an airport. If you're gonna be taking the Sandworm Express, you can teleport behind someone's main base, you can teleport anywhere on the map. In Fremen, like I said, it can take risks going away from your own territory because you can be suffering less supply chain drop, and also you can just do supply drops as well if you need to. It's really, really good. So, one thing about the Fremen, they don't really play the politics. They don't really care about it too much. You have very limited access to the Landsrat, which is the Senate of the Imperium, basically. So, I kind of like that because the Fremen, I've never been a huge fan of the diplomacy stuff, although I think when multiplayer gets added to this game, I probably will, so when we do our first multiplayer playthrough, I'll probably play the Harkonnen and just be like scheming and palpitating, but nonetheless, they don't really mess with that. And once you get your hegemony up, you get more thumpers, and yeah, it's pretty cool. That's that. Once you get 10k, your military units get a big power buff, which is pretty cool, and that is it. Now, as far as what we're going to be doing for our characters, we have Shani here, and she has the ability to incite rebellions. Now, that's okay. I'm honestly not as huge of a fan of what she does here, because she plays the intelligence game, and we're going to be playing more for spice and more for authority over Arrakis. We do have Stilgar here. He's pretty good. This is the guy I want to play, because every village you capture helps you find more sieges, and on top of that, he gives you authority for every single spice field that you find. Now, he synergizes super, super well with Mother Ramala, because she allows you to start with the Shai-Hulud temples, which usually is an endgame tech, and on top of that, she reveals all of the spice fields. So if you team these two characters up, Stilgar, for example, he wants to get all the spice fields to generate authority, and then she shows you where all these spice fields are. The last character is pretty good too. He's like a combat character. He gives your units a movement speed buff and also gives them like a lone wolf type ability, which is kind of nice because you can single-handedly take villages with some of your more elite units, which is cool. Thanks for making a sick day off work tolerable. Hey, I got you, man. We'll get you through it. We will get you through it. Yeah, the game is pretty much finished except multiplayer. Yeah, I mean, and honestly, I haven't run into, I know it says early access, but I have not run into a single bug yet. No issues whatsoever. Yeah, not a single crash, nothing that like didn't work. I mean, I think they're going to be adding more stuff in. They'll probably add like the Saudukar and like the House Ordos and like all that kind of stuff as well. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. I think it's really going to shine with multiplayer. Like, I cannot wait to jump on here with a few friends and just, like, be scheming and palpitating because there's a lot of crazy stuff you can do. Now, I don't know what difficulty we should play on, honestly. Last time we did normal and we had some good scraps for sure, but I could do a little bit harder. So you can enable, you know, which type of victories you want to do and whatever, right? Yeah, so you can turn off certain ones. Political hegemony. Okay, that's pretty cool. You got the AI players, AI difficulty. I guess we should probably go on hard because I think we've been... last time, you know, was one of my first playthroughs and I was still able to kind of steamroll once we got to a point. So let's put it on hard and see how we do. All right, map size. Oh, you can actually make the maps different sizes. Interesting. Sandworm activity. Oh, you can put it on high. All right. So this is kind of fun in terms of options that you have for customizing. Yeah, and like a multiplayer game, I can see that being pretty rad. Okay, so we're going to go on hard today. I think that'll be fun. I think we can handle it. All right, so we have our characters. We're all set. Let's do it. Let's have some fun. Yes. Thank you all for joining. What's Aaron? Did you run into... Yeah, the worms gave me the business a couple times, but the Fremen are much better. Excuse me. The Fremen are much better with the worms. So you can see we start and we have all the spice fields visible to us. It's a really cool trait of the Fremen. So 1, 2, and 3. So the way I'm going to be playing this is just going like spice, spice, baby. We're going to be just the Dark Lords of Spice. Now with the Fremen, you don't really have to worry again about the political thing as much. You can choose to just kind of ignore the Imperium if you want to. Hey Taren, longtime lurker. Thanks for making my quest design days more tolerable. Hey, I got you, man. So we're going to be beginning by building Ornithopters, and we're going to build a warrior and a skirmisher. And this guy can go scout, so we'll send him up here to check this out, and we'll go explore the spice fields. And there you go. So villages are always on these like kind of like desert crater type like terrain, so you can just like go there and scout that out. And for the Fremen characters, you have the warrior, you have the skirmisher, and then they have a couple other really cool units. And honestly, guys, micro actually really, really matters quite a bit in the PvP. I've been doing a little bit of gameplay on my own time, and microing units makes a huge difference actually when you're like playing against a strong army. So with Fremen, you do not get your spice areas targeted by sandworms, which is awesome. So the Fremen, of course, they're kind of more homies with the worms, so you don't need to worry about them as much. Okay, so let's go here. Doesn't look like there's anything that juicy here, so we're gonna go discover this other spice field down here. Just need to get our characters up. So yeah, like if I'm moving in hostile territory, my guys will suffer far less. Now Fremen have a debuff, so when they hit you, they debuff you, and then this guy has like 30% AoE explosives. Yeah, they mess up armored opponents. Alright, so we're heading over there, and we found another village here, so let's do this. Would I recommend the game? Yeah, I like it a lot. I've already played it for, you know, quite a bit of time, and I really do enjoy it, so. But yeah, I mean, watch the stream, you know, see if it seems fun to you, and, you know, make your judgment from there, for sure. Alright, so we're gonna take over this village really quick. I'm gonna be playing quite a bit quicker today, because I've certainly improved. Is this multiplayer? Not yet, it will be probably in the next few weeks. And multiplayers, you know, honestly, if you're someone who enjoys, you know, mostly multiplayer games, I would just wait for that. Like, I think that's where it's going to be really fun. Alright, so you can also put these on auto recon, so you just click this and they're going to go look around on their own. Alright, so take that guy out and we're fine. Yeah, we have another spice field down here. Yeah, the Fremen have a lot of cool troops. You have the Fediakins, I think. Yeah, these guys are beasts. For each enemy unit in combat, they get stronger. You also have a caravan. Infiltrators are probably one of my favorite. These guys, they get plus 80 power on their first attack. So you can actually cycle charge them. You pull them in, you attack, you retreat them, and then do it, and they just like murk things. So much damage. Alright, so you've taken the village. The desert will surprise you. Alright, let's go ahead and take control of that. Obviously, the Fremen don't collect power either, so you don't have to worry about power cells, which is really nice. Because you ride around in the sandworm. So to ride around with these guys, you use the thumper. You place a thumper, a sandworm appears, and then like you can go pretty much anywhere on the map. It's really, really good. So you can like jump across and do all sorts of crazy stuff. Ready for patrol. All right, so he's gonna go explore this. We'll head down this direction and then get that other spice field soon. But you always want to be building the plascrete first, which is the building material. That one's like super, super important. All right, so first things first, we could build a spice building right here, which maybe I should. Yeah, I probably should. Because I don't want to miss the first embargo of that. So now we have tech tree. So what I'm going to do is go for the... yeah, which one do I want to do first? The processing plants are pretty good. Probably going to go local dialect studies. This makes it so it's cheaper to annex villages. Sorry, guys. A little bit of allergies today. Goddamn. Goddamn. I need some water. I need some milk. And then this one gives you knowledge per village, which is really, really nice. Lay of the Land is also great, too, because it allows you to infiltrate Arrakis even more. So let's go this way. Sorry, guys. I'll clear up in a minute. All right, heading south. Let's go, baby. So we have the Spice Collector coming here. What sort of special resources do we have? Oh, rare elements. Okay, that's pretty good. That we definitely want to get the... we need to get the structured warehouses for that to build the maintenance center. So the spice is flowing.
On the lookout.
Slowly. It's getting there. And we're gonna hustle south and we're gonna conquer another village here so we can speed up the game if we want to. So let's go ahead and head down here and take this out. And if you guys have any questions, do let me know. We'll look at all the unique technologies as well. Because Fremen have a bunch of unique technologies. Every single faction does. So we can do that right now. So as you look in tech trees, you'll notice that there's a little yellow flag in the bottom right corner of a bunch of these techs. So all the different factions share technologies with the exception of the unique ones. And so for example, they have the Desert Mastery, they have the Desert Command, they have Spreading the Faith. Now, pretty much my entire game plan in this playthrough is going to be focused on this one tech, which is called Spreading the Faith. You get +2 gold for each neutral village on the map. So you're like, you want to go make sure your opponents aren't settling and you liberate the villages. And then every single time you liberate a village, you get 1,000 gold, which is crazy, crazy good. You could just skyrocket. Yeah, the Fremen pay the Space Guild, correct. Yeah, you don't pay the Emperor. You're just paying like a bribe, basically. All right, so looking good so far. We're going to take this over and we're playing on hard now, so the AI should be quite a bit stronger. I've never played on hard before. And you do want to micro your units if they're near death, so I'm just going to run it back to the base to let it heal. Obviously, you don't want to be losing that stuff for no reason. The spice refinery will be set up soon. There we go right there. Karate chopping here. Any chance for Blood Bowl content? Yeah. I think I will at some point. For sure. Love the Spice Force content. Looking forward to multiplayer streams. Yeah, me too. I really am. All right, we're going to take that over. So we need to get water and we need to get Plascrete. So here's something about water. You hit the I button and you're going to see the wind level in each region. Wind strength right here is 4. Wind strength up here is... Why am I not seeing a wind strength value? I think I... Oh, it's 3. And then down here it's 6. So you always want to build water in regions with high wind strength. Like 4 is pretty good. 3 is like kind of the minimum you would want to do, but if it's less, you don't want to waste time building water there. Yeah, you don't want to. All right, so we're taking over that village. Our character healed. We want to get a Plascrete factory. That's going to give us additional building materials, which is one of the most essential things in this game. All right, so now we're going to head back here, move over. How do you feel the game translates? There's some things that don't like make perfect sense lore-wise, but honestly, I feel like the factions certainly carry their flavor. Like, the Atreides can take over villages without even attacking them, and they play really heavy diplomacy and, you know, all about the honor. The Fremen certainly are cool. I like the fact that I don't have to play politics with Fremen. I think that's pretty fun. So we got a new village. This village has a specialization in rare elements. Unfortunately, we can't build the processing plant here because we don't have the structured warehouses tech, which is going to be our next plan. So in the meantime, we're just going to go ahead and set up the wind trap so our people don't run out of water. Boom. And that will give us 3 water for every single wind value we have in that region. So everything seems to be going okay so far. No drama. We're not in the negative in anything. And we'll move down, take out these villages, and continue expanding our glorious empire. Yeah, looking around, we have deep desert. Ooh, yeah, this is deep desert here. How am I going to get to the middle of the map? That's like where I want to go. The middle of the map has a bunch of unique landscape. Oh god, sandworm. Oh, sandworm! Okay. Even though the sandworms are, you know, kind of friendly to the Fremen, they don't really care too much. All right, let's go ahead and have you auto-recon. Turn, would you rather get 100k or flip a coin for 1,000,000? Oh man, that's a tough question, Pwn. I don't know. So we don't have quite enough authority to take this over yet, so we're going to go ahead and leave one character to occupy the village, and then we're going to send our troops to go scout for these little events on the map. So Plascrete's coming down, and Plascrete and Sandworm, combat, and ongoing siege. Alrighty. So let's go ahead and move over here, do this. And so we can explore this, and this is going to give us an extra Ornithopter, which I don't even know if I really want it. I guess it's free real estate, so might as well take it. So we almost have enough authority, and once we finish our water trap here, we should have enough water as well. So we'll take the free Ornithopter and have it go recon around. It'll help us kind of get a lay of the land a little bit better. I really like the auto recon feature. Okay, so we have our first agent, and since we're playing the Fremen and we care most about the land, the agent produces 100% more infiltration. So this agent is actually designed to infiltrate other factions. Now, let me break it down for you guys in terms of how this system works. So for anybody who's new to the game, let's look. So these are missions. Missions are basically done by spending intelligence. Intelligence is generated by having your agents being active. You can see I get 1 intelligence here, I get 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here. However, if you're infiltrating enemy factions, you get more intelligence. So if you want to be doing like more crazy missions, you want to infiltrate specific factions. Anyways, each of these missions, there's a couple basic ones, poison the reserves, as well as a probe setup. But oh no, this isn't basic. But anyways, each mission requires a different type of infiltration. So this one requires Arrakis infiltration. This one requires Arrakis as well. This one is a spacing guild infiltration, which is really good because it allows you to drop supplies and heal your troops in foreign lands. For this one, you need to infiltrate the Chome. It allows you to set up a ghost market to steal resources from other players. Stealth, this one's a ceasefire. And you can just see in the bottom right what they require. A combination of intelligence and gold. So basically, yeah, I need to infiltrate Arrakis for this one. Arrakis is my favorite. I think that's my favorite infiltration. Now, you're probably wondering, what missions do I unlock by infiltrating Atreides and Harkonnen and all these bad boys? Well, if you infiltrate those factions, you have enough infiltration. So two infiltration levels with Atreides, for example, and then you have two infiltration levels on all these, you can initiate an assassination mission and kill their faction leader. And if you succeed, then that player is actually removed from the game. It's pretty brutal for sure, but in order to stop that, you would want to put agents in counterintelligence to keep them from infiltrating you. So for now, I'm just going to be going for Arrakis. Arrakis is good because it gives you additional authority right here, which lets you expand faster, and Fremen love doing that. So that's what we're going to be doing. Very, very fun. All right, so we're about to get this village. We should be able to get it in just a moment. Our two factories are finishing. We got our water trap, which I believe we'll finish here in just a hot second, so we can just fast forward a little bit. And where do I want to go next? Ooh, this is actually a good region. This one has Plascrete down here. And these regions here are deep desert. Deep desert, pretty much you don't... Oh, this is good. So you see this? This little gold icon means that this is a special region. This is not only will give you hegemony, which is your win condition to win the game, but it also has a special aspect about it. So this one gives you 100% more processing in terms of your building materials, the Plascrete. That's really good. So we're for sure going to go take that next. All right, so we got to hang here. You got to stay in the village while you're doing this. Yes, and looking around, our Plascrete is growing. And now we almost have the local hubs, which will give us knowledge per village. So that's what I like to do with Fremen. I like to play the spice game, and then I like to go knowledge spam. Knowledge lets you tech super quickly, and I think it's a very strong combination. I played a full playthrough with Atreides on my own time, and I played a Palpatine style where I was just scheming like nonstop, and it was pretty fun actually. Yes. Like, politics are really strong in this. Like, if you have the Senate, you can just get a ton of power and nerf other factions. Alright. Yeah, this little yellow meter underneath them is actually the supply. Yeah, this is a special region here. We want this. We want this bad. So we need to move up there and get that village. We gotta watch out though, we could be raided at any time. Sorry, guys. Damn, allergies today. Curse the Baggins. Curse the Baggins! Alright, so heading up here. Looking good. Looking good. What's that, guys? Let me get some water here real quick. Yeah, so the regions are a little bit random. They're a little bit random. I believe the map spawns slightly differently. Like, the glacier in the middle is always there, though. There's some things that are uniform across the board. All right, so the processing plant's kind of what we want to build next here. I can go for more Plascrete. I think that's always pretty good. I'll set up here and take this. You can check how much authority I need. So I need 72 authority to take this over, but by the time it's ready to capture, I should be good to go. Lich109 asks, does your spice tithe increase when you destroy another faction? I actually don't know. Jesse, thank you for the annunciation. Ah, of course, a raid down here, so... That's kind of annoying. I'm like super far away. So what we're going to do is you guys are going to get to see the sandworm riding for the first time here. So I have to take out this and then can I make another soldier? Yeah, I'll just make a warrior and send him down there. Although my siege is being hit. These big storms actually really mess you up. And this character is actually almost dead. So I got to pull it back. Oh man. Okay. Is this region like super? Yeah, I lost a troop here. Oh, that's right. The special regions are more heavily defended. So I'm probably going to have to pull back. It's fine. Lesson learned. And now that village is being raided and I don't have any militia there, so I gotta make sure to get down there and deal with that. So let's just run down. Yeah, you can see my supply is dropping and this storm is actually a little bit of a problem here. If my character gets caught in that, I could be in trouble. Thank you for the donation, bud. Appreciate that. So we probably want to get like 3 units before we try and take that. Oh god, don't run into the sandstorm. Come on. I think we're safe. Yeah, we'll get this one next though. We'll just keep developing these regions for now. So Lay of the Land is really good. It will give us an extra agent slot to infiltrate Arrakis, which will max out our authority. I don't think we need to use the Sandworm. I think we can get down there, because it's only one raider trying to capture our village. So we're going to just hustle down there and hopefully be fine. Yeah, so special regions are more heavily guarded by militia, so I forgot that. So we'll heal here for a second. You always want to typically set up... Oh, this is actually a really good region. It has 5 wind value plus also Plascrete, so maybe we just do that one first to be safe. All right, let's go take out this raider. Yeah, we do want that, and also there's a spice field up here. This is, like, pretty juicy, and honestly, like, we're very protected. See these big open deserts? People cannot attack us from there, so literally, like, they can, but they'll die on their way through. So the only ways I can really be attacked from my position is from the north and the south. So it's a pretty, pretty solid one, and I can use the sandworm to teleport across the desert, whereas the other factions can't. Alright, so we have another agent. We're gonna infiltrate Arrakis. This agent gives us, Solari... per infiltration level. Okay, that's pretty good. Trade request.
Let's get to business.
So, influence and a knowledge agreement for... I don't really want that. It's fine. Village under siege. Yeah, I know. Construction complete. We paid the bribe, which does give us victory points. Spice tax is paid. You do want to do that for the sake of victory, even if you're playing Fremen. Alright, so... Let's go ahead and expand this a little bit. So, this is our spice operation up here. Let's do this. How's the wind level here? It's only 3, so it's not very good. So probably what we do is we build a manpower building. This is a unique Fremen building, the Temple to Shai-Hulud, which is very good. It gives you 20% resource production to the region and all adjacent provinces. So if I own this one, it would buff this and this. It's not worth building right now, but eventually it will be. So we're going to build manpower production so I can get more military. Manpower is used to field armies, and also you need it for villages and things like that. So, yeah, it's going, man. Good, good. Finish them. So we will take this village. Yeah. Oh, no, we already own this one. Yeah, okay, that's right. Do I have enough to build another warrior? I'm a little bit tight on money at the moment. But the manpower flows.
Arrakis is our home. We'll hide our tracks.
We'll just go ahead and make sure we get this back. So we're decapping their liberation right now. Alright, so... I guess we could just go take this village. It's probably a little bit more of an easier one than that unique village. Plus, we're playing on a harder difficulty this time around, so the AI is going to be cheating and stuff. I mean, I still think we're... Yeah, we're still in first place, because we've expanded. That's the advantage of going authority builds, is you can expand super quickly. All right, so we'll take that out. We have the Plascrete factory over here. We need to get another spice business going. So we actually... We actually have... Fair amount of Plascrete. Yeah, it's coming up pretty quick. And this region is going to give us a bonus amount, too. It gives you 50% more, so I think that's going to be good. All right, so we'll save the building slot there. We're expanding very quickly, though. Sometimes you have to be careful. If you overexpand, it can be really hard to kind of protect everything. And here we actually have a spice node, so let's go send you to do this. And we'll take this over. How's our stockpile? Okay, we don't have enough of a stockpile to be really greedy yet. We do need to get that processing plant to get this region going for the rare elements. We really need to do that. Alright, so we're taking over this bad boy. We have a fair amount of Plascrete. How's our business doing? Let's go ahead and put a crew to our spice harvesting operation by spending manpower. And the village will be ours soon. So, I think I'll... Man, there's so many good regions near me. This is crazy. Alright, so Plascrete factory. See that? Its upkeep is Plascrete, so it pays for itself, which is really nice. And since this is our... I want to put militia in, but I'm really kind of tight on money right now. Okay, so we got Lay of the Land, so now we can fully infiltrate Arrakis. Next up, I'm going to go for the Structured Warehouses. This one gives you maintenance centers, makes them cheaper to build, and those are really good buildings. I'll show you guys those. And also, it just makes buildings cheaper to build, but more importantly, it allows us to build processing plants, which is a unique building for that region. All right. Man, I need to definitely fix my economy a little bit. So we have 18 days. Let's sell more gold instead of stockpiling, or sell more spice now that we're going to have a second spice operation online, and I think we're chilling. Okay, so let's build a spice collector. Boom. So we're going to get a second spice operation going, and now we have 2 spice fields this early on, which feels very good. Our ornithopter did scout this, so we can take the free spice from that. And that pretty much puts us up. Now the Landsrat is here. You'll notice that the Fremen, like, you really don't have a whole lot going on here. Like, you have your influence, which is kind of cute, but... You have very limited effect on the Landsrat. Same with the smugglers. It's mainly between Atreides and Harkonnen in terms of, like, who's going to be having a good old jolly time there. Yeah, we have thumpers right now. I don't need to use them, though. Thumpers, you know, if I'm being... need to get across the map quickly, I will do the thumper. Next up, though, I'd like to get another warrior. Money's a little bit tight, and their upkeep is 6. So I should probably wait till I get the processing plant here before I start doing that. But we have a pretty good little spice stockpile. I can even sell more. I can be a little bit greedy here. So let's do that. And let's get another... That's the processing region. Plascrete, don't need to worry about there. We have another spice plant coming up here. And then we have a plascrete factory there. Okay. Seems good. This is what you want. This is like the good shit right here. This one gives you 1,000 hegemony and lets you build a water extractor. So you can just get a shit ton of water. Although I don't know if Fremen can build water extractors. I'll have to take a look here. For now, we'll go up and get this region up in the north. Okay, the plascrete factory's done. How's the wind in this region? Wind is pretty good, so let's build water traps to augment our water, which is very low. Trade request from homeboy. So he wants influence for money, which I think I'm actually down for. Because we don't really care about the political system, you know? We're just going to take his money and then get a bigger military. So let's go ahead and build a skirmisher here. All right, cool. So once we get that third trooper, we should be able to go take that special province up north. How do you feel about the combat in this game? So it's actually a little bit more dynamic than it appears. Like each units have like specializations and then, oh my God, the stupid sandstorm thing. Okay, let's run up there. Do we have a raid coming?
How can I?
Indeed, okay, he's just talking shit. Lovely. Oh, a siege. Okay, sieges are really good. So sieges are local Fremen and that live underground. And basically you can trade with them and improve your relations. Once the relations are improved to the proper amount, you can basically get this permanent buff for your entire faction. In this case, if I befriend the siege, I get 20% Solari production. Like, across the board, it's crazy good. Also, befriending sieges gives you victory points. And what's really good about Fremen is you can befriend sieges and enemy lands. So even if you don't own the territory, which you normally have to befriend the siege, you can get a ton of value out of that. This is actually not good that the storm is coming, because it's just going to kill my troop when he pops out, probably. Oh boy, okay, sandstorm's coming for us. And we're pretty close to getting the processing plant. That looks fine. Council vote, okay, authority for elected faction, sure, let's just put our... Yeah, see, we can only vote with influence. Fremen do not have free votes. So, like, I guess we'll vote for this, I don't know. Recruitment cost, yeah, sure, because we're already done recruiting for now. And building costs, yeah, looks fine. Like, Fremen have very limited tools in that. Okay, hustle it up. Okay, avoid the sandstorm, buddy. No. Bad sandstorm. Oh my God, looks like I just barely got out of that. You see, there's like little things you gotta watch out for like that. Friggin' thing, man. We're getting the spice, baby. Spice, baby, yes. All right, so down here, how's the wind? We got the water. Let's go ahead now and start getting some knowledge buildings. The research hubs are really useful. We have a nice spice stockpile, so we can pay our troll toll. And these guys can heal up, and then they can head to the north. So I'm speeding up the game when you guys see me doing that up in the top right. So what would be really good to build in this region would actually be the temple to Shai-Hulud. Because this one will increase our village resource production by 20% on both sides. So these two regions will both get augmented. So we're going to build that right here. That is usually an endgame building for my faction, but Mother Ramalo means that you can start with that. You can't hide in your settlements, no, because the settlements get wrecked by the sandstorms too. It's not just the troopers. Okay, so we're gonna do that, and then I'll also build a maintenance center over here.
On the lookout.
Do we have the spice operation? We do. I believe we have extra manpower, so let's add a crew to that so we can augment our spice income. Down here, I could get attacked at any time, so did my game crash? Okay. Instead of coming down here, I'm gonna add some militia. Militia are defenders, which cost manpower and gold, but only one time. And then if I get attacked here, they will defend that settlement, so I don't have to like run my army all the way across.
If we can.
A nice spot for an ambush.
All right, so let's head up here. Let's get the goodies. We want this region. It's very nice, and we have a ton of authority because we're playing Arrakis, right? So we have the good old Fremen business going here. All right, so let's do this. We have a new agent, so that agent can fully infiltrate Arrakis. That's going to allow us to expand like crazy. And cool, we're going to take this one, no problem. Just got to watch out for worms. They often are attracted to the combat there, and they can certainly enjoy themselves a little bit too much. Okay, any other notifications? Siege detected. We can start trading with them. So this siege will trade us, let's see. They want 10 water for 20 Solari. So if I give them 10 water... they'll give me 20 gold back, which I think is worth it. Plus, it'll also start improving our relations so I can make an alliance with them. Excellent. So we're going to be a little bit low on water for a minute, but we can just go ahead and build a wind trap in this region, and that will totally solve it. Yeah. All right, looking good. We'll keep karate chopping these guys here. Looking around. We definitely need a wind trap here as well. So let's get another building slot, and then we'll do that, because there's six wind up on that peak, which is going to give us a ton. Like, these are range units, and getting into melee with them actually shuts down their DPS. So, like, again, there are little micro plays like that. So we'll do that, take over that village. And this has six wind up here, so we definitely want to get a wind trap here. And then the last building is going to be a maintenance center, which reduces the upkeep of buildings in adjacent regions. It's really, really good. So, yeah, so we're getting that Siege Alliance down there, and another spice field up here, and another unique region. So what is this unique region? This is recruitment office resources. Okay, that's actually kind of good for manpower, and that could be like our northernmost operation. We'll have like a big kind of L-shaped. Currently, we're at 1,800. House Atreides is actually ahead of us. House Atreides cheats. They always have a super high score. So we'll probably go after them first, to be honest. Okay, so we're taking this over. Looking good. And now this region is processing plant. So that's going to be for Plascrete? Yeah. Processing plant. Oh, no. Oh, man. This is actually... Yeah, okay. This is a gold region. Okay, I was a little bit wrong. We're about to get the tech that lets us build those. So that's going to be very nice. So we control that village. Let's go ahead and get some militia here so I don't have to sit and defend it. And we can head back down south, I think. Now, although we do want to keep expanding northwards. We're going for like an expansionist playstyle. Uh-huh. So the water trap is coming there. That'll solve our water problems. We want to get a processing plant here very, very soon. As soon as this tech finishes, we're going to be good. Okay. Let's see. And where is it? The Shai-Hulud Temple, processing plant, 128. That's the good stuff. So our development is finished. We got lay of the land. And do we have the processing plant? We do. So now let's decide where we want to go next. Arrakis Secrets. This one gives us more spice crews. More agents here. I really like spreading the faith. Spreading the faith is so good. 1,000 gold when you liberate villages, and also you get Solari for each neutral village. I think we're going to go this direction and get spreading the faith. Fieldwork is also super good because you get 20 gold for every special region you control. So the Fremen like kind of worship all these sacred sites, right? So with Fremen getting spreading the faith and fieldwork just seems so strong. 20 gold per special region, which for us is going to be like plus 80 or something. It's going to be crazy. So maybe we do that first. So let's go this way, then down to get spreading the faith afterwards. Okay, so now we need to build those special buildings, the processing plant. So we build that. That's going to give us 30 gold. And then we can also build it up here, and that's going to give us 60 gold. We're just going to be bathing in it, so yeah, so far we're in pretty good shape. We haven't taken that region, but the spice is definitely flowing. Yeah, Fremen have the strongest authority income in the game. Yeah, it seems like the way to play them, honestly. I really like it. Fremen can go agents, though. They have some really cool agent tech, but I think actually Harkonnens are one of the better agent factions. Okay, so I could just run through this region, but this has wind and spice, so I think I gotta do it. We have a raid detected, and I do not have any defenders. Alright, so... Like, the sandworm, I could use it here, but... Well, how do they... Oh, there's actually, like, a breach they can get across here. Okay, I didn't think I was vulnerable from that region, but... The militia won't finish in time, unfortunately. So we gotta pull my troops down here to stop this raid. Otherwise, I lose this village. The noise on the soundtrack sounds like your phone vibrating. That's pretty funny. Alright, so how are we looking? Yep, definitely want to get some maintenance centers here. Let's go take out these raiders. We have the processing plant coming, and we will get that one eventually. We don't want to run into the deep desert. Something you want to watch out and try and avoid if you can. Alright, let's do this. Go, go, my minions. Yeah, we're going to get the military tech soon. We don't need it when we're clearing raiders, but as soon as I like foresee myself getting into open conflict with another faction, I'm going to be switching to military tech. But I'm telling you guys, going for spreading the faith before you start fighting other factions is so good. Because you get 1,000 gold every time you essentially take down one of their villages. It's absurd. It's very strong. Yeah, Fremen get more authority per spice field. That's why I'm aiming for all these spice fields. And plus, I have my agent who lets me see where all the spice fields are. You guys will see some of the late game, like, Fremen military units are so cool. Alright, so that's secure. Now we can go ahead and do this. Do we not have enough? No, it's 500 Plascrete. That's actually a shitload. What do we want to add up here? So, wind is okay here. It's not amazing. Probably just get a plasticrete factory here. Yep. The desert. Our income is crazy good. We probably want to like collect a little bit more spice. All right, so again, we have like no influence. We literally have no say in like anything here. Let's just put it on Atreides since they're the strongest. Unit power decline, and then like we could use our 34 influence, but Fremen, like I said, don't have. Yeah, this is actually good for us. Okay. The desert will surprise. They really don't care too much about that. Yeah, you can pause the game and do everything. I just don't do it too much because, you know, I played quite a bit already, so. We're playing on hard this time around, so you guys can see kind of the range of difficulties. Okay, so this is a spice field. Let's go up and get this. Take out this other spice field. And then this special region, and then that could be our northern border. We see Atreides up here. He actually isn't that expanded, I don't think. Oh, he probably did peaceful annexation to all these, yeah. Because Atreides can just snipe lands by just using peaceful annexation. It's very, very strong. Okay. So we're going to go get this village. That'll give us another spice field, which is awesome. And we are on our way. Advanced engineering does give us health on all buildings, which is kind of cute if you're being attacked. It's honestly not that useful of a tech, this one. But we will take this down, and we might want to invest in more military at this point. Infiltrators are awesome, dude. Infiltrators are the shit. PvP isn't in the game yet, but it's going to be added soon. So infiltrators actually have a fair amount of micro. They have a backstab. So the first time they attack something, they get you, and you can also give them camouflage so your opponents can't see them. That's like, Fremen can get all sorts of sneaky, tricksy traps, which is very, very good. I honestly feel like Fremen are much easier than Harkonnen. Harkonnen, like, you're constantly having to micro the rebellions and all that kind of stuff. It's a... Oh, nope. I don't feel like feeding Shai-Hulud right now. So pull back this way. Alright, looking good. Take him down. Let's go check how we're doing with the siege down here. 15... So once we get to 100, we can get the goodness going. Trade request from Atreides.
Greetings.
I'm good, homie. Thanks. I feel pretty strong right now, so... Let's go ahead and colonize this. And... Sandworm detected. Sandworms are our friends, thankfully. We don't have to worry about our crawlers being eaten, too, which is really cool. I do want to get... Yeah, we need to save that for this village up here to get a spice business going. Okay, seems good. So let's go ahead and get spice collectors. Spice, baby. New village controlled. And then we expand up and take this special region, which is going to give us more hegemony. We're currently in first place, but Atreides, yeah, the AI is much stronger on this. Usually I'm just... the past couple playthroughs I've done, I've been so far ahead, but they're actually kind of holding pretty close to me in score. Yeah, here's Atreides. He's got a decent little pocket. Yeah, here's his capital over here, I think. And Harkonnen's over on the west, but I think we probably own the most land. I don't see anybody being able to keep up with us. I agree with Turin. Fremen felt easier than Harkonnen for me. Yeah, Harkonnen, I think I need to play more like shenanigans with them instead of like another siege. Ah, we found another siege. Very nice. So this one wants 10 water for 4 spice. So we'll do that. Start developing relationships. And then once we have 100 relations with them, we can get 20 manpower permanently across our whole faction. Crazy good. And the Fremen can befriend like so much easier on those bad boys too. And also our main building, we now have 2,000 hegemony, which means we can build in our primary base. So we can build these like fat buildings, which I'm not going to do yet, but we will get to that soon. It takes quite a bit of gold to do that. All right, so how's the wind in this region? It's not the worst. The temple to Shai-Hulud will be actually very good right here because it'll give resource production to these two provinces attached to it. We're ready to hunt the invaders. There you go. That's the spirit. All right. I could do a little bit of trading if I want to down here. I'm probably not going to expand this way. So what I think is going to be a good idea is actually to get a missile turret down here when we have enough plascrete. So this will give us a little bit of security. So it would actually take like a substantial raider force, and it means we don't have to come protect this. So we're setting up a missile turret here because they can't attack through the desert. They would have to come through here. So if any raiders come, the militia plus the turret will handle that. Now my southern border is like totally secure. Yes. I'm chilling. What does the garrison look like here? Ooh, they actually have a garrison of 4, so I might need to get more military to deal with that. So let's get another warrior. All right, very good. Industrial regulations. They voted to punish me, so that's why my plascrete is being lowered a little bit. Mm. I have paid the troll toll. So let's head down here. Do we have any militia here? I don't think we need them. We can run back up there relatively quickly. No, Fremen, yeah, the caravans are interesting. You have infiltrators and, yeah, they're mostly melee. Harkonnen have really good ranged, and so do Atreides. Atreides have these, like, snipers that are really good. And you can micro them, actually, like a StarCraft unit. Alright, so we can now potentially almost build a... Yeah, we need more Plascrete. Okay, so how's the wind production here? 5, actually. That's pretty good. So let's get a wind trap. Yep, we have the Temple of Shai-Hulud, which in ally villages in the region and its neighbors, right? So these neighboring regions are all going to get a huge eco boost from the temple there. It's a really, really good building. So let's just go capture this one. It's a Plascrete. Looks pretty good. We have our fourth warrior. I'd say this playthrough is going pretty good. I think we're going to win it much quicker than we did with Harkonnen the other day. All right, team. Let's head over. Let's go capture this. I can't wait for this to be PvP. The schemes are going to be so funny. Hasn't seen the power of Fremen range versus enemy bases yet? No. I haven't finished... I haven't really played Fremen too much. I did a little bit last night to familiarize myself, but... Okay, so we clear this out. And then... We definitely want to go north. Atreides is going to be... Oh, shit. They just took over a ton of land. I'm going to have to beat them down. Wow. Atreides just got super jacked. And we want this. This is a special site. I think. Is it? No, it's actually not. It just has a ton of wind. Okay.
We will help if we can.
Alright, so we're getting the crumping going here. Sandworm detected, so we want to pull our infantry near the village, because sandworms don't get too close to the villages, so right now we're actually safe. And do we have the spice going here? We do. Let's assign some manpower to that. Oh, our manpower is actually negative right now. Yeah, we need to get a manpower building stat, so let's go ahead and do this. Because I built more military and I didn't have the manpower to scale with it, so... A little bit stupid, but it's okay. Take control. Yeah, manpower. We need to do it. Because if you're negative in something, you see my units have 100% health regeneration penalty right now. So they can't heal until I get the manpower situation solved. We got the turret down here. I do want to get a maintenance center here. It'll reduce the cost of all these nearby buildings, which is really good. Yeah, Fremen don't really play the council, which is kind of cool. It's a whole different... I will do an Atreides playthrough soon, probably, where I will do like a Palpatine style. So yes, we do have a worm transport that flies us around the map. Yeah. Alright, so we got this. Let's get the Plascrete, because that's what this region specializes in. We have an Ornithopter. Let's grab one of our Ornithopters to check this out. Cool. And our manpower should be fixed as soon as that building up there is finished. Should be. Okay, so 300. The main building. How are we doing? We can actually build something, but we're a little bit tight on Plascrete at the moment. Yeah, because we're expanding so quick that it's really putting a huge tax on our building materials. I think the last expansion I'll do is going to be up here on this special region. Then I'm just going to go sniping for special regions to try and win the game, because with the fieldwork tech, I get a huge benefit for every special region I control. Because the Fremen, you know, they worship the land and all that stuff, so. Yeah, so, like, other factions can punish me via the council, right? So if you're in a PvP game, yeah, Fremen are going to be taking over a lot of space, but you can have these big council votes to penalize them, so they just have upkeep penalties and all sorts of stuff. Like, there's plenty of counterplay for that kind of stuff. Okay, construction possible in your base. So let's take a look and see what we want to do in terms of special building. So I'm thinking of going for the economy building here. This one gives +3 knowledge, which is super good for research. Statecraft, I think the administrative hall is pretty good. This one gives authority production. But I think for now I'm going to go for the research center in the big district. So you'll notice there's districts of different sizes. The way this works is if I build 3 economy buildings at a big district, I unlock the final bonus for economy. Whereas if I build a military building in one district, with a district that has 1 capacity, I get the minor military academy buff, right? So we're going to go ahead and do the research center in the big one, which is super good. Like, knowledge is great. It's great. All right, cool. Knowledge is power. All right, so the manpower thing should be fixed. Yeah, our manpower is back in the green, and it looks like there's a raid coming here. I do have militia, but the raiders might be able to win because they don't have, like, a turret here or something. Man, you see the raiders going across the desert? Man, their supplies are going to be super low. They might actually just die. Yeah, these raiders are going to die. Let me just, like, show you guys how this goes down. Point of interest investigated. Let's go ahead and take the money. So check this out. So the raiders are here. We've been paying our tax, and their supplies should be dwindling right now. Yeah, they are, but less fast. Yeah. We'll come down and help. I'll do the sandworm for you guys in just a second, just to show you what it looks like. Okay, we have another agent, so we're gonna go for the spacing guild. This one gives us manpower, which we do need, and also lets us get the supply drop, which is one of the best infiltrations in the entire game. It's so good. Yeah, and look at that. We get hegemony by taking these units out, which is nice too. Yeah, their supply is running very, very bare, but it looks like our militia are also paying the troll toll, so I didn't think they would come across that desert or be able to make it, but I think the raiders must have some like natural passive or something. Alright, let's go ahead and do this and get a research center when we can. Landsrad is coming up again, and my terrible influence, I can help, I guess. Arrakis is our home. Yeah, and you see they're dying from no supplies now? Like, see how the health is dropping right there? So they're paying the price. The bazaar building in every single slot gives you 40% higher research in every category. That's really good. Alright, Sandworm's coming. Shai-Hulud has come to help us. You guys want to see the Sandworm Feast? You're going to see it right now, especially if they stay right there. Oh no, he just disappeared. No, he didn't. He's still out there, isn't he? I don't want to, like, send my warrior out and have him get... Oh, no, there he goes. See? Thank you, Sandworm. Truly, truly a Fremen friend. Okay, let's rebuild our militia here. Do we have enough? Yeah, we got to leave combat first. Alright, that was pretty sweet. So, we'll run you guys across. Let's get this and get a maintenance center, which lowers the upkeep cost of Solari and Plascrete for buildings in its region and adjacent regions. So this is going to get an upkeep reduction. This will, and so will this. That's super cost effective. We're listening. A nice spot for... The raiders certainly did not have a good time in the desert there. Shai-Hulud came for that booty, and he claimed it. Are we looking up here? We got the manpower. We got the spice going. I think we have how many spice fields right now? 3. And do we have a crew in each one? We do. Very good. So Solari production per controlled region. So we're going to go get this top one up here. Yeah, you can't build the Polar Cat building. I discovered that last night when I was testing them out. Okay, so that will save us quite a bit. We paid the bribe. We have a pretty good little stockpile. Our gold income is great. Honestly, we're in a very commanding position, I think. Atreides is right tied with us in the score, so they're for sure who we need to take out. We're going to go liberate all of those Atreides lands soon. Once we get the field work and spreading the faith, we're going to go, like, just ham over there. We're going to ride a sandworm all up in their face. Looks like the raiders are attacking them. So how are we doing on the sieges, too? That's something else I want to check. So this one's at 77 friendliness. Relations, I should say. So when that's maxed out, we'll be able to do it. Is the Sarlacc related to the Sandworm? Yes. I'm sure they're best friends. Cool. Seems good. This is where we got attacked before, so let's rebuild our militia. And eventually you can get better militia, too. Some factions have, like, more potent militia as well. Like, Atreides get, like, a special one, I think. Yeah, like more, you know, more militaristic funness. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this. We can get another building slot here. Plascrete production, yes please. Are smugglers a playable faction? Yeah, they are. Everything you see on here is playable in terms of the core factions. So we'll take this over. Another special region. What does this region give? Recruitment office, yeah. That's nice. So that'll be good for military stuff. And we're not gonna... So interestingly enough, with Fremen, this technology, Spreading the Faith, you get a bonus for each neutral village on the map. So for every village that hasn't been taken by a faction, you get a bonus. So like, once you get that, like, I think I'm chilling in terms of my base, because my base is fat and it's going to be hard to defend. We're for sure going to squash the Atreides though, because they're our biggest political rival, or just rival in general. I don't know how they're beating us so bad on score. I guess we're playing on hard now, so... Yeah, this will be where we launch our attack from. Do they have any special regions? I kind of want to just go snipe special regions. Oh, here's another siege here. Yeah, we're trading with them, so they're going to be our friends. You guys, let's go ahead and get the recruitment office, since we have a bonus for that here. Do need to get more water as well. This region, we got 300 Plascrete. We have the temple to Shai-Hulud here. Let's go ahead and get... water's only 4 in this region. Let's go ahead and get a research hub. That'll give us extra knowledge so we can tech up faster. That's always a good one for Fremen. We have 12 knowledge, which is pretty good. And militia, we want to get some militia, so let's do this in case we get attacked here. And we will be doing the sandworm riding very soon. So right now we're getting spreading the faith, I think. Yeah, that's what we want to be getting. Yep, cool. Spreading the faith is so good. And look at our income now, it's pretty great. Pretty good, my friends. So what do we need to build the second building here? We can also get the military one. This one gives you 5 manpower per controlled village. Okay, that's pretty useful. Influence, and this one gives you authority gains. So what buildings do we want to get here? We don't care about the intel. We don't. The bazaar counts as an economy, military, and statecraft building. +2 influence per ally siege. Okay, we don't really care about the influence thing. So I think we're going to do the administrative hall in a single province. Although the military one's probably a little bit more pertinent. What do we need to unlock these? The Chome branch and then the recycling vats. Requires Dune Wanderers. Okay, so we're going to hang tight on that then. Because we'll have to get that tech soon. But we do need to get military because we don't want to go fight Atreides with just like these potato units, right? Harkonnen, we could even go on a liberation campaign against Harkonnen. Pretty much whoever is like a threat to us, we're going to go liberate lands. Because every time we liberate, we just get 1,000 gold and we just go bananas. All right, so we got that. We just get a Plascrete factory. There's like no wind over here, so we're chilling. And do we have Plascrete, Spice Collectors, Recruitment Office? We can go ahead and build the temple to Shai-Hulud, although I don't know if it stacks. 1 max. Okay, so let's just get a maintenance center. That'll make everything cheaper. Uh-oh, something's going on here. Okay, this siege is now friendly, so what I can do is I can click on this, and I can form an alliance. It costs me 2 authority, but it gives me 20% Solari production. So we do that, boom. And now look at our income, it just skyrocketed. Plus, we also get victory points for befriending a siege. You can see we get 400 victory points for that. Yeah, Sadukar aren't in the game yet, but I would imagine they will be. I think it's only a matter of time. Let's go ahead and go for a research hub. Get a little bit more knowledge going. Yeah, maintenance center will make all this stuff cheaper, which is great. And we're pretty close to spreading the faith. This one, you'll notice, when this is done is when we get down and dirty and start fighting. Is there anything else we want down here? What do we have? Windtrap, Plascrete, and Research Hub. And I believe here we have a temple to Shai-Hulud, plus a maintenance center, so that's pretty good for us. Pop this. Let's go ahead and get... Manpower production isn't going to be an issue, I don't think. No, we don't care about the... I honestly don't think the hegemony building's that good. Yeah. Influence isn't that useful for us either. Let's go ahead and just get the recruitment office, I guess. To max that region out. Alright, we're rolling in it. Let's see, what else? Up top. Missile turret could be reasonable here, considering. But I think I'll build some of the other buildings first. Water in that region is god-awful, so let's just get knowledge. So we can tech up a little bit quicker. And we're going to ride the sandworm over... Ooh, Atreides is actually kind of getting beaten up by the smugglers a little bit. Okay. We need to finish this big tech, though. But with our knowledge, it's going to be pretty quick. Only 4 days remaining, so... Looks good to me. Alright, so we got all these regions more or less maxed out. This one's not quite yet. And what do we want to get here? Let's evaluate the temple to Shai-Hulud. So we have one here. I don't know if it stacks. It's something I should probably learn. That's right, I forgot we had this shit up here, too. We got 4 wind. Let's get some water traps. Not a bad spot for that. And do we have knowledge here? Let's do knowledge. Knowledge, knowledge, knowledge. Yes. We're getting all that knowledge. Yo, turn, should I buy Warhammer 3? Honestly, it depends. I don't think it's in the best time to buy. You might want to wait for Mortal Empires, which could be a little while, but... Yeah, it's hard to say, man. It's a complicated answer. I'd have to know more about you and your interests and all that stuff. Okay, so yeah, our manpower is mostly capped out. So we're going to need some military tech here soon. We're about to finish spreading the faith. And we're pretty good on score. 5.3 to 4.7. Smugglers are in last. There's another siege over here. Are we trading with them? No, we're not, I don't think. Are we? Okay, now we are. Now we're trading with them. Great. So, just got to grab all those sieges. It's one of the things the Fremen do incredibly well. Yeah, we're going to be getting the elite units soon. very, very soon. Okay, so knowledge coming up here. Probably going to get a missile turret up here next. Man, our resources are just skyrocketing. It's crazy. Everything's just so smooth. It seems so much easier than Harkonnen. All right, development research. Now we want to get the... Yeah, these. Because the Dune Wanderers and Desert Mastery, this one will give us military units, cost less water. And it unlocks the Recycling Vats building, which I believe is the big boy building. No. It's down here. Recycling Vats, I think, is right here. Yeah. 5 water per building in your main base, and also you get hegemony for each water-producing village, which is really good. So we're going to go that route real quick. Although, we could just like hit the military kind of hard here. Yeah, military base. That gives us the infiltrator unit. And call to arms, this route right here, getting survival training, ground command, and call to arms is really good because it unlocks your Fedakin units, which are great. That was not a compelling answer for one of the biggest brand ambassadors. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. Turns in mid-game, yeah. We're in mid-game right now, correct. So we're going to go military first. We can go ahead and set up... Let's see what military we want to get in general. So we only have one big province, so military is going to be our next most important thing. So we're going to go ahead and build the recruitment center right here. That'll give us just training slots and also more manpower, so that'll be pretty good for us. We are very, very rich at the moment, though. How's this doing in terms of development? Let's grab this. There's no water here. Don't care about influence. Could build a missile battery here. Yeah, Atreides might attack us. I think it's worth it to build a missile turret up there.
On the lookout.
And we're very, very... I mean, our research is very quick compared to other factions, most likely. Cool. Developed. Man, I cannot wait for multiplayer in this game. It's going to be so much fun. The temple to Shai-Hulud. Yeah, not a very useful one up here. Our manpower is fine. Let's get another knowledge production. Landsrad Council. I mean, we have 103 influence. Solari upkeep. Yeah, honestly, nothing here is like, I don't care about any of that stuff. So this game is going to be PvP. Yeah, right now it's single player at the moment. Which is fine, you can just learn the game. And if you really mostly care about multiplayer, you probably just wait a couple weeks and it'll be there. But when it is multiplayer, guys, I will cover that and do some streams. So you guys will get a notification as to when that's going to be going down. Definitely going to sandworm some people here. I know I haven't rode the sandworm yet, but it's because I don't have the military units. Okay, so now we can build infiltrators, although no, we are missing the recruitment slot. We should get more command points when our this tech finishes, as well as our building in our main town center, so we can build a bigger army. Command points kind of dictate like how much of whatever you can build. Water here, it is 4. We could do a military base. Upkeep reduction is always pretty good. I don't believe we have one up here. Do we? Actually, we do have a maintenance center here, yeah. A little redundant. Water. Yep, water's fine. 4 is okay. Yeah, you can only build one of each kind of building in each region. Yes, correct. Okay, raiders are coming. That's nice. It's free real estate. I believe we have a missile turret here now. No, we don't, actually. Unlock this. And how is the wind level in this spice region? Looking. There's some sort of like weird poison here. I think somebody did an agent action against me. Yeah, so supply drain and also the units don't... oh, look, the supply drain is actually hurting the raiders there, which is pretty funny. Enemy hegemony has reached 5,000, so very, very close to myself. Trade request, no thanks. This siege is our friend, I think. Yeah, so that siege is friendly to us. This one is getting there. This one is actually fully friendly too, so if we form an alliance with these guys... It will give us manpower production plus 20%. So let's do that. Now we have 2 siege alliances. So we're just cackling right now. We're going to be able to field some huge armies. Okay, we need to get out of this region. This region is poisoned, so we can't regenerate here, which is kind of annoying. Okay, so now we have more military building slots because we just finished that technology. So I'm going to build a couple infiltrators. Infiltrators are really good. They're backstab units. You're going to see some like big burst damage coming in when they start fighting. Yes, let's just put a missile turret here so I don't have to like defend this all the time. We got 2 infiltrators coming. They're gonna be creeping. The creepy crawly. Okay, this region is almost fully developed up here. There's no sense in doing water. Military base could be okay here, considering we might fight in this region, but I don't think we will, so... I guess we just do a temple to Shai-Hulud. I don't know if it stacks, but we'll find out here.
Yes.
Okay.
We'll hide our tracks.
So it's almost time for the Fremen to get a little wild. Call to arms is coming. We have our military building in the main base. The second one is... The barracks is super good. We need to get this before we fight. This one's super, super good. Unit regeneration, health for your units, extra experience. It is mega, mega powerful.
We're ready to hunt the...
So now we need to go start liberating some villages. You guys ready for the funny business? And I think we need to set up some operations before we do that. So we're going to gear up some supply drops, which we'll put it up here so you have it ready. And also a gear sabotage. So we can sabotage the enemy reinforcements for the fight. Professor Pone says, turn, next question. You are in the Roman arena and they're coming at you from every direction in their intent to kill you. How many third graders do you think you could take? I mean, how many are in the arena, Pone? I think I could take a ton of them. A ton. I mean, although I'm pretty out of shape right now, so maybe not as many as I'd think, but I think I could take a ton, dude. Just like a ton. Yeah. For sure. Just, I mean, and am I armed? Or is it just like fisticuffs? You need to give me a little bit more detail so I can give you a thorough analysis of this. All right, barracks is coming up. That's going to be unlocking the military investments, which will give us +2 power on all our units, which is actually a lot. And then it's time to satisfy the grudge. We're going to go just chain liberate all these lands. And if they don't have airports set up, they're for sure not going to be able to keep up with us. Let's get some more infiltrators, 2 more. God, the poison is so annoying. Let's just go back to the main base. And an infinite amount? Well, that's what Lich says. Okay. Infinite amount. I mean, eventually you're just gonna run out of, you know, steam. Your cardio is gonna give out on you. And that's gonna be where you pay the price. Let's just do another maintenance center. Sure.
We're listening.
Okay, so we got 2 more infiltrators coming. We're about to unlock the a very elite unit. I could take a lot of younglings for sure. I used to be a pretty good athlete. I mean, right now I'm not, but if we're talking my prime, then I think I could take a ton. But right now it would certainly not be as many. All right. Looks good. Looks good. Yeah, almost everything's like fully developed right now. Our main base is getting nice and sauce too. When this finishes, we'll create some elite fighter units. I think, although I guess we could just go fight with this. I think it's fine. All right. So we finished call to arms. High command is okay. Army logistics. Yeah, regain supply. Yeah, we're gonna go this way now so we can get the water benefits. You guys ready for the Shai-Hulud? Just punch, kick, and bite. Oh my god, yeah. I don't know, that's a good question, dude. Third graders. Because some third graders can be pretty big. It's a hard one. Let me dwell on that. What if it's 29? Maybe. All right, guys, we're going to place a thumper. So we place the thumper here. And let's evaluate where we want to go. So we're going to be attacking... Who's the next closest to us? Okay, so Harkonnen and smugglers are pretty weak, but Atreides are pretty strong. We could... Oh, this is actually pretty cool. We could go up here and steal the special region afterwards, too. And for the Fremen, units that give you special like fuel cells, they have this special building called... do I have any building slots where I could show you guys? Hold on. It's called the Ceremonial Caves right here. And it gives your entire faction +5% power in exchange for a little bit of spice loss. Our stockpile is really good too, man. Yeah, let's just be a little bit greedier here. Alright, guys. So place the thumper. We're gonna place it, and now you see the entire map becomes like available. Not entire map, because we're not late game yet, but I can jump straight into their lands. Okay, this feels pretty good. Yeah, we just like move up here. That's their main base. We just like sweep all these regions. Where's their base right here? Yeah, okay. Okay, so check it out. It's so cool.
We are listening.
Let's go, baby. Yeah. And then they jump on the sandworm. Look, and he takes you. Yes, sand beast. Take us to the promised land. He's taking a little bit of a crappy route, though. I'm not sure where he's going. Are we actually with this? Oh, we are. Look, it's like a bus, dude. Yeah, this is pretty rad. So the sandworm's giving us a nice journey. Domingo, join the stream, and I wanted to know what the Fremen playstyle has felt. It's very much like expansion, playing the land, as you would think. Like special regions, massive expansion, that type of thing. But this is where we just go bananas, and you guys are going to see why in a second. Do I have enough for that? No, we don't. Okay. Okay, guys. So the first operation is coming in. And we have our supply drop ready. So if we start to run out of supplies, we can drop supplies to our people. Where do we go first? Aha! We have emerged in the Atreides lands. Isn't that cool? Like, other factions can't do that. And eventually the sandworm gets the ability to do that on the whole map here. So we're going to go ahead and do this. So just watch the DPS from the backstab guys. Like, look how quickly they chop through these. Oh my god. Fremen just kill shit so fast. It's crazy. So Atreides will probably respond in kind here, and if they do, we sabotage their weapons. Yeah, so we just like absolutely goon to that region. So now what we do is we liberate the village. We send it back to a neutral village, and we get 1,000 gold, and we also get a benefit from it being a neutral village because we get, you know, essentially something for that. And now to heal up our army, which is in foreign lands, we use a supply drop. Boom, that's gonna refresh our supplies. We can go ahead and queue up another one. So we have it ready, and that's going to heal our army to full. So we're just going on a liberation campaign right now. Yeah, like, boom. And you can see the Atreides have some rangers up on the high ground, but we're just going to straight up liberate everything they love. We're going to give it back to the locals, which is great. It's very flavorful. Anything we want to do here? Not really. We're fully developed. The main base, yeah, we have not gotten the water tech yet. Oh, this one, we could do a little something-something. So how's our manpower? Manpower's really good, actually. Jesus. I guess we just take the hegemony building because there's like nothing else to do there. Oh god, not a sandstorm. God, dude. Stop.
Yes, Liet.
Because now the village is going to be saved.
We will help if we can.
Can I like sit here with you and do that? No.
Yes, Liet. We are listening.
Of course, just some wild ass sandstorm just decides to come right there. We're going to have to re-liberate it, which is going to be very annoying. I don't know if this guy's going to get away. No, we lost one unit to that. It's okay. We can build the big Chungus unit, I think.
We are listening.
All right. Just waiting for the sandstorm to move. How do you get more thumpers? They passively regenerate. Yeah, you have a maximum of 3. So, like, the other factions can get around quicker, like, more often, but you have more power on less charges. Okay, so we got to go back and re-liberate that village. Atreides could be fighting on the other end as well. So I don't think the garrison is replenished, so we can just move back in and start the liberation again. Alright, so we have another agent. Let's put some agents on counterintelligence, maybe? No, we'll do spacing guild and then we'll do counterintelligence. I just gotta take out Atreides, man. Because when they're gone, I'm so far ahead, I don't think it matters. Alright, so influence production, sure. Landsrad Guard. Okay, so we actually want to make sure Harkonnen get this. Because if Atreides get this, they're going to attack us. So we're going to actually put all of our votes into Harkonnen getting the free units. And water upkeep, let's decline that. All right. We want to make sure Harkonnen get the... Because if Atreides gets those Landsrad Guard, they're going to jump us here. And that's going to be brutal, so... All right, seems good. Yeah, we could take over some more land if we want to. But I think just sniping special regions is going to be the way. We can even sandworm up to the north and take that special region. Because, again, we are playing the lay of the land build where we get bonuses for owning, or field work for owning special regions. God, my economy is so much better than the Harkonnen playthrough. Granted, I know how to play the game now, so I didn't know how to do it in the first playthrough. All right, so we're going to liberate this, then we're going to liberate this. We're going to liberate everything until all they have is just their haggard main base. And that's going to give us like 1 million gold. What can we do here? We can build the recycling vats now, which will give us hegemony based on water production. Also increases our supply, and yeah, it gives us water in general, which is great. So what is the last building here that we can build? The Chome branch. Economic lobbying is what we need. So where is that? Economic lobbying. I'm, like, looking around to see. Oh, shit, it's all the way down here. Okay. Yeah, we can do this, too, to amp up our spice production also. We're playing on hard this time around. But like, again, I think this game's really going to shine when we get the multiplayer, guys. I love it right now, but let's see. Oh, yeah, we want to start trading. And are we trading here? We almost have enough to ally that siege. Great.
What do you need?
We're going to butter some bread for sure.
We're here.
All right, so move north and liberate this. It takes a little while to liberate the villages. Because you're sending it back to a neutral state. So watch my gold. I have 8,000 right now, which is just insane. I'm definitely going to want to expand a little bit too. So I can have this like military force out here and then build some troops at home to go like conquer, yeah. So now I'm going to start losing supply because I'm in foreign lands. But again, Fremen get a bonus from that, right? So we've liberated this. Now you can see it's gone. And we got 9,000 gold, which is gross. So we're going to move in, take out the base right here. I believe Atreides is fighting. Yeah, look, Atreides is fighting on the western border. That's why their army isn't meeting us. So they're just busy fighting and we're just like backstabbing him, which is great. Going after the most powerful guy. So let's go ahead and liberate this shit. Liberate! All right. So do we have the means to make more military? We could build a couple of you. Siege is detected, yeah. So now we can make an alliance. This siege gives us manpower production. Form alliance. Boom. So we have another alliance with the siege. Trade request. Yeah, no, I'm good, dude. I don't need anything from you guys. Yeah, I could. I could leave one infiltrator behind for sure. But the reason why I'm keeping my armies together is because I want to put some respect on their name. I don't know if they're going to be coming at me with a lot of stuff. Atreides is definitely right on our tail. So is Harkonnen, though. So we might have to go, you know, liberate them a little bit as well. All right, so we got the desert mastery. So look at this, 30% supply train in deep deserts, and our military units in the deep desert gain camouflage so they can't see us coming. So we can actually run through the deep deserts now and we get camouflage while we're doing it. High command probably is pretty good. Military threat, command post building allows you to do the spacing guilds, and we get the caravan, huh. It's kind of cool. Let's go for high command though. And I believe now we can build that other building in our main base here. Should be able to build something new. Nah, okay, it's still building, it's fine. Alright, team. Oh, I ended the alliance, did I? Oops. Oh, end alliance, okay. So let's just make sure I have all the sieges going. We're gonna pause real quick. Form alliance, we have that. If I'm not mistaken. Okay, so that's good. So that's formed. That's formed. They're still going. Yeah. Oh, look, and it gives you vision over the whole region, too. Man, that's really nice. Yeah, I fixed it just now, guys. Don't worry. Yeah, I was wondering why my hegemony dropped. I was like, what happened? We're, like, maxed out on authority, dude. We have too much. So, considering we have good authority, what we can do... Look at the big Chungus. He's so glorious. We can get trade agreements with them for knowledge, and so let's try and see if Chungus wants to do it. Did he do it? Because one of the downsides of trade agreements is you take a loss, and we'll do a Solari production as well.
What do you want?
And we'll do a knowledge production. Solari, yeah. And we're going to do a knowledge. So we just got like a massive spike in our like knowledge as well. Yeah, we're at 28 knowledge right now, so we're just gonna like rip through these. Okay, looking good. Village has been liberated. All right, let's go to the next one, man. We're just gonna work our way up to the special region, which is what we want. Also the spice fields. Maybe we do take the spice field, actually. I think that could be pertinent. Because, you know, spice is great for us. Okay, we're hustling. Yeah, House Ordos isn't in the game. I'm sure they'll be added as like a DLC or something. Atreides is just getting their butt kicked. I don't even know where their main army's down here. Doing God knows what. I think they're fighting the smugglers. So, in the meantime, we're just liberating all their shit. Yes, go. And our supplies are getting a little bit tight. So I think we'll take this region because it's spice. And then we'll take this too. Go, Fremen. Hustle up. All right, the assassin guys get in there with the shanks. And we'll see it. Oh yeah, I've seen Event Horizon. It's a great movie. Yeah, I know, for sure. It's a classic. It could even be a prequel to 40K. Uh-huh. So I don't think we fully developed this region yet. No, we did. Okay. We definitely still want to take over more regions, I think. Because now we just have so many resources, it seems like silly not to. And if our... You know, if our supplies get low, we just use our supply drop that we set up earlier. Let's go ahead and take control of this. So we'll take control of these two regions. Could even do, like, yeah, control, like, make an attachment to our base here. That could be a decent thing. Okay, what can we do at our siege? So we need to get the, like I said, economic lobbying. But the military high command will give us a bigger starting army, or a bigger army to work with. Okay, so you guys can head up here. I don't think we need to worry too much about. Yeah, let's get you back in there. Cool. I don't think I need to put too much respect on it. This region doesn't seem particularly worth it. I mean, although we could just like do massive amounts of development here, man. Maybe it is worth to just take all these. Create a little bit of buffering. Okay, so we'll take out this village real quick. This is just a neutral one. And, ooh, we actually are a little bit tight on there. How much is this one? 289. Okay, so maybe we could just hang here for a minute. Then head on up here. Our supplies are refreshed. Uh-oh. See, this is what I was worried about. The Atreides have come. So what we need to do is run this unit, if we can. We'll do a supply drop in the region. I don't know if we can win this fight, actually. That's a big army. So we'll do a gear sabotage here. That'll lower their power in this region. And then we're going to do a supply drop right here. That'll give us healing. Okay, so the Atreides army is coming to fight, but I think we got them. They have too many range units. Although our infiltrators are getting a little bit beat up, so we want to pull you back. Who else is in bad shape here? Yeah, they're getting cut to pieces. Yeah, chase them down. We got to make sure to stay on top of the range units, so we want to get you back here. And then you can come and help finish off this warrior. We probably have more military upgrades than they do. They're really on the back foot, you know. Operation against me. What is it going to be? Poison the reserves? Ah, it's just stupid. All right, so let's just do a temple to Shai-Hulud. Yeah, I figured they would eventually fight back. Have a little bit of fighting spirit there. Okay, how are we doing? It looks like we won. So we need to go to our missions and get another supply drop ready so we can heal up. Okay, so we're just going to hang here. Looking good to me. You can head this way. We'll take over the spice fields and then we'll head to the west and take down that special region to get some more hegemony. Yeah, we've really set Atreides back super far. So now we need to see, okay, maybe we head over to Harkonnen and give them the dirty now. I think it's time, and we'll have some elite units very soon. We'll make one of our elite boys. Unfortunately, we can't, like, fly around quite as easy. Okay, Landsrad wrote. Yeah, so Harkonnen has the Landsrad guys right now. No, stop attacking their buildings, please. Okay. So just fast forward while we take this over. I mean, Atreides might come and try and defend this. Mission successful. Okay, so we fully infiltrated Arrakis now, which is cool. The Spacing Guild is also being infiltrated. We do need to get some counterintelligence going, though. Alright, perfect. So, yeah, it does take a while. When bases have, like, a lot of buildings in them, it takes a while to get that going. Man, our plasticry production is just off the chain, too. We can do one of our statecraft buildings, actually. So, we only have small provinces now, so... Influence and authority gains, yeah, and hegemony gains. Gain a portion of your hegemony as Solari. Intelligence agency. That's not bad, but we'll just do the administrative hall. Almost got it. Does it matter, it doesn't really matter where you place the buildings, in my experience. And we have the, Fidakins coming. The elite Fremen warriors are completely fearless and dreaded by all. No unit is better fitted for skirmishes, yeah. Even when vastly outnumbered.
Always stay alert.
Okay, development research. What do we want to be doing next? Definitely want to get the logistics. The economic lobbying here. This will also sauce up our spice business. And we now have the high command, so we can build another elite unit. So those guys, the elite units there, can just go and solo villages and expand us. Well, this army will continue. We're going to do a supply drop here soon, although... No, we don't need to, actually. We're going to take over this whole operation, which is going to be great. Atreides is pretty much trash can. I think we... Oh, yeah, another spice operation here. Hell yeah. We have such a good stockpile of spice. Let's be really greedy and just, like, sell most of it. Yeah, cool. Just the casual 14,000 gold. No biggie. Okay. So we've taken over this village. What buildings do they have? So they have water, which is fine. Intel, which we don't care for, so we're going to demolish that. And Plascrete. Okay. So we should be able to heal our army here, too. Yep. Everyone's healing. Good. We'll let them heal up. We have the elite boys. Can you move your agents? I think if I move my agents... I'm actually not sure. If I move my agents, I think I lose my max level on this. Like, Chome is decent. So we can put one on Chome here. Let's see what happens. It looks like it's going to stay, but we'll keep tabs on that to make sure. Yeah, you can overlap missile turrets, correct. So your missile turrets are one of the few things where placement actually kind of matters. You can see our authority's down a little bit because of all the treaties we have, but the treaties are giving us like a freakish amount of resources, so...
The desert will swallow them.
Alright, let's go, team. Okay, so we want to get a spice harvesting operation going here, spice collectors. Unfortunately, since we use different spice technology, we can't, like, just use theirs, so we have to rebuild it. Also, let's get some heavy militia. Those are, like, the elite militia that I unlocked. Oh, I keep forgetting these side missions. Jeez. I literally keep forgetting these. Exploit a new spice field. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, whatever. None of those are, like, super great anyways. Do we take this region? No, I don't think so. The donkeys heal and resupply your army. Okay, that's good. I haven't played with those. We'll unlock that tech soon. I'm just trying to get all the big buildings, like the bazaar. And... All right, let's go. Let's hustle. We found their other spice fields. Oh, Atreides is nearby. Okay. We want this region though. This is the good shit right here. And now we have the two big boys. So these are our elite units. They for each enemy unit in combat with this unit, they gain stats. So if they're outnumbered, these guys get stronger. They're super cool. What they can do is go push this way. We can have them line up here and then Atreides is nearby with some military. Yeah, they have some rangers and troopers over there. Okay, we want this special region though, because we have a ton of tech to really benefit that. Nice. And what does this one do? This one has the ceremonial caves. Nice. Alright, so let's get a missile turret. That will help against, if the Atreides want to come and try and get their base back. T, what about the Tool Song Schism? I know the pieces fit. Yeah, I know that one. Alright, so let's get you guys to go take this village. Our authority's a little bit low right now, but it's okay. It's all those damn trade agreements. Operation against me, what is it? It's probably something from the Atreides. Well, our elite units will easily take this, this forward village here. Yeah, look at him just kicking butt over there. Nice. We're all healed up. We got this. Let's go ahead and get the spice caves, the ceremonial caves. That will give us power across our entire faction, which is awesome. And now for you. Do you want the temple, military base, knowledge? Yeah, we can get a spice production building, actually. And let's get some crew. So now we actually have a tech that lets us put more crew in. So we're going to go double the crew on all of our guys. There we go. Yeah, the big boys are here. They just like solo shit. Yeah, they're definitely gonna take out that entire village on their own.
We're here. Listen to the sand.
Listen to the sand, indeed. All right, let's prepare another mission. Let's do. I think we're fine. I think we're okay. What's our hegemony? 10,000 right now? Yeah, we're really crushing it. Harkonnen's getting a little bit bold though. Smugglers are actually almost dead. Wow. Smugglers have been getting sandwiched, so it's just going to be me versus Harkonnen in the late game, I think. The Chungus, the jewel.
Listen to the sound.
It begins. Let's go fight Atreides down here. Take this spice field. Ongoing siege. Ah, yes. Okay, so we don't have enough to take this over, so we can just let these guys chill for now. Until we have enough authority to overtake that, which is going to be a while, actually. Shit. Our authority production isn't amazing.
What does Liet command?
We'll just, like, liberate this, although I do need the spice field. Okay, it's coming back. It's coming back. All right, so let's take down these Atreides troopers and rangers. They're fighting on two fronts. That one is gonna be done. Pretty sure we're sitting pretty cozy here. And we can use the sandworm to magically teleport if need be. Man, Fremen just kills stuff so quickly. It's pretty crazy. This gives us access to the middle and to another spice field here, which feels good. Yeah, okay. Communication request. Man, a lot of notifications going down. I noticed you were neglecting this valuable territory. Okay, whatever, dude. I don't know what he's talking about. Siege detected. This one is about to get there, actually, so we can form an alliance with them, like, in a second here. Come on. And what does this siege do? Warrior recruitment cost, warrior training time. That's actually not that good, so I don't think I'm going to do that. Because it costs me authority. 337, wow, it's going to take a while. All right, let's just liberate this then. It does become harder to expand. And let's go ahead and see, like, what resources do we actually need? There's only one wind up here. Let's get knowledge.
What do you need?
So we're liberating that village. Rebellion. Ooh, a rebellion in my base, huh? Okay. So, you guys... We don't have enough authority to expand very effectively right now, so we're just gonna go... Where the hell is that rebellion? Okay, that's pretty troll. It's gonna take me a while to get over there. We'll see if the boys can do it. Meanwhile, these guys will liberate. I could ride it. You know what? I haven't been really using the sandworm very much, so let's just do it. Okay, so play Thumper. And we're gonna just take the Sandworm Express. I don't know why a rebellion happened. I think somebody did an action against me to incite a rebellion, because there's no reason for a rebellion to happen there. Alright, team. So the Sandworm crew is... They're heading up there. Shai-Hulud is hooking the homies up, and they're going to be heading north to deal with the rebels. Somebody for sure did an action against me. And the mission that it is, let me show you guys, it's probably... Like, if you go full intel, man, in infiltration, you can literally spam rebellions in somebody's base. Like, it's actually really strong. Ooh, we can actually spend gold to buy shares, yeah, to get hegemony just to win. But, it's called crowd manipulation. This one? You can just spam it nonstop in the mid-game. Like, you can... If I was playing a PvP game, dude, you could just go crazy with that. Alright. So the elites are there handling that. We're decapping this. Definitely want to get missile turrets all over these, like, these really kind of foreign bases. And heavy militia. We got the demo, too.
We're here.
Alright, so Atreides is just getting straight-up trash-canned. Where are there more special regions? That's what we really want. Okay, the middle of the map. For sure. Okay, so we've done that. Let's run up here so we don't run out of supplies. Our defense force... has dealt with it. Looks pretty good. Oh, Atreides, did they take that from me? Did they? No, I don't think they did. I think they just happened to set up over there. Okay, well, at least we know where we're going next. Communication request, who wants it? As neighbors, we all have to deal with each other. Let's keep it cordial. Okay, sure, man. You got it.
Swift as the wind.
We could sandworm our way somewhere. You have to be more careful with Fremen, though. The Sandworm can only be used so much, because we have to wait for it to reset here. What can we do in the main base? Okay, so we can do another statecraft building. And we do not have the economic lobbying yet. We're about to get that. Okay. So for you, influence, we don't care about that. Counts as an economy military for all purposes. Applies the district's bonus one more time. Oh, that's pretty good. So the bazaar applies the district bonus, which would be statecraft. Yeah, I mean... Honestly, neither of these are that useful. Did they give me anything else? Yeah, screw it. Hey, Forrest, I'm having a great day. Thank you for asking. Having a great day, my friends. Oh, Atreides looking a little bit angry over here. Where are they going? Where are you guys going? Is the mighty sandworm going to have to emerge? We've liberated most of their lands. They just have, like, a couple random little bases now. Oh my god, Harkonnen just ate the smugglers. All the smugglers have left is their capital here. Atreides is going to be, like, so far behind now, though. Okay, we're going to have to sandworm this shit. When we see where they're going. Okay, yep. We're not going to let you do that.
We're one with the desert.
Okay, place the thumper when they're done moving. And the dreaded sandworm will... Oh, can he not go that far? What's wrong with the sandworm? Is he sick? Oh, it has something to do with his region. Okay, let's run over here. Shit. The sand, that's a bit of a problem. We have a couple elite units. Okay, these elite units might be able to protect this with the missile turret and the militia there. Our Fedakins might be able to fight this since they're very elite. So hopefully they can hold off this Atreides attack. Maybe certain regions the sandworm doesn't like to go through or something? Okay, this is deep desert. Shit, this is really risky, but I guess we'll just go here and waddle through.
Yes, Liad.
Thankfully we have the stuff that lets us go through the deep desert. Okay, our elite units are fighting with the militia. We also have a missile turret. I think we get this. Looks like we're fine. Yeah, look how quickly we can go through the deep desert. That's pretty nice. I haven't really played the smuggler, so I don't know the trade off the top of my head. Uh-huh. Let's go ahead and do, Plascrete, sure. I mean, it's really not that useful anymore. Let's do the hegemony building.
We're ready to hunt the invaders.
Oh, okay. It honestly looks like the Atreides got their butts kicked by my elite units. Because they get stronger for each enemy that's fighting them. So, like, when they're outnumbered, they just, like, kick ass. Alright, pretty awesome.
We're ready to hunt the invaders.
Our supplies are replenished. I could just take out House Atreides, honestly.
We make less noise than a mouse.
Listening.
Do we have any authority to take over this region? How much would this actually be? 198? Okay, you know what? I don't like them having this border territory. So we'll let those elite boys do it. I think we can go somewhere else now, so let's go find some more special regions to take over. I think the middle, the glacier, it doesn't really do anything for us, but... how's the siege? Are we trading with them? Let's start trading with this guy. And we can start trading with this guy. Alright. The sandworm, yes, he developed an allergy to the sand, so he's off duty right now. I really love these elite units. They're so cool that they're like these Lone Ranger units that can just kind of do their own thing. Let's take control.
We're Arrakis Claws.
Where do we want to go next? I mean, I could just keep liberating. Oh, a special region. Okay, here we go. Research hub, too. Yeah, that's where we're going. All right.
Yes.
All right, Shai-Hulud. Let's get going, homie. There's work to be done. Did I misclick that? I think I did. There we go. Now we can go everywhere. Cool. Alright, so we're going to just pop up next to their village. Dude, that's so cool. The Sandworm Express. they all jump in. Oh, of course I remember the Tremors movies. Yeah, those were all fun. Oh, one of our characters is actually pretty close to death here. You got to try and run him away. I mean, we're so rich, we could just rebuild him, but he might escape on his own. Nope, they're down for the count. Alright. Let's rebuild him. And where's our army? Have they arrived yet? In the Atreides lands? I don't know if this guy's going to be able to solo all this. I don't think so. So let's run him back here. And yes. So we just... Look at that. We just emerge next to their base. It's so cool, man. Yeah. It's awesome. We're just going for those special sacred sites, basically. Yeah, this one is a special research hub. Take control. All right, Atreides. Yeah, their army's hustling back here. Oh, they have Landsrad Guard. That's why this army's so strong now. Okay. And let's get some skirmishers to move up with that army, too. We should be able to hold that base. Give it to me, Precious. Yes, let's go ahead and build this. And water isn't useful here. Manpower, we're like overboard on. Maintenance Center will reduce the cost of one of those regions. Influence, again. Kind of useless. Yeah, man. Do we already have a temple to Shai-Hulud here? We don't. Okay, let's do that. Actually, that's pretty much useless because there's no research production
We're
here.
Ready to hunt the invaders.
And Plascrete it is. Always useful to have extra building materials. Okay, so they don't see a lot of our army, so that's why the AI thinks it can win, and then all my camouflage units pop out and backstab them. So good. Let's pull back you injured, guys. Couple of Atreides Rangers get karate chopped there and circle beaten. Okay, let's move back. And they're eyeing this. I believe my two new units have finished. And what can we build here? Can we do this? No, we don't have the tech yet. We're about to get the economic lobbying, which will let us get the good stuff. Come on, give me the village. Give me the village. We're special region sniping at the moment. We're at 11k hegemony. The next closest is like Harkonnen at 9.6. So, yeah. They have Landsrad Guard though. These guys are really strong. They're like incredibly strong. So we gotta watch out for them. Put some respect on their names. Yeah, and our troops should be able to get this region. We'll move them up and then we can snipe that side region from them. Nice. So they have a knowledge hub, which is good. Influence, which we don't care about, so we're gonna delete that. Water, wow, they have a water trap here too, that's terrible. There's like no water in this region. We just want to get the research hub, yeah. Okay, cool. So missile turret. Get the missile turret to poke them if they try and run close. Let's get some heavy militia. Unassigned agent. So let's just put this agent on counterintelligence to make sure we don't get infiltrated as... Because that's probably like how I could lose this, is if somebody's infiltrating me and assassinates my faction leader. That would not be fun. Nor would it be chill.
We trust you, Liet.
Probably get the caravan soon, too. Oh, that's a big Atreides army ship. I do have the heavy militia up there. I don't know if they'll be able to win that.
We will help if we can.
I might have to use a sandworm to get up there. Let's see how the fighting goes first. Because I do have a missile turret, so maybe the missile turret. No, they have Landsrad Guard. They're going to win that. Yeah, Atreides isn't going to stop. We gotta just finish them off here, I think. They don't have much left. They have, like, a couple provinces.
Arrakis is our home.
Arrakis is our home. Alright, now we just go down to Desert Command, which will give us just command points. You get power based on how many spice collectors you have. It's a pretty strong tech. And then here we can build the Chome Branch. Cool. And we have 29,000, jeez. Yeah, we're crushing it. We're crushing it!
Arrakis is our home.
Alright, so how are our militia doing here? Oh, they're running! Why are they running? Oh, it's because I'm attacking their base. Okay, that actually works out well. It's a pretty good deal.
You
guys can go take this base. Let's move up there and do that. The main base actually hits pretty hard, so like we gotta... Probably gonna lose some units here to it. But we can always, like, we have so much money, we can just reproduce. I love having infiltrators, they're so cool. I don't think we're gonna be able to hold this. Oh, they used a ceasefire agreement here. So we can't fight in this region. That's pretty funny. Whoa, what is this? Yeah, see, they used a ceasefire, but his main base can still shoot me because it's not in that region. So that's pretty troll. Yeah, we're gonna buy some Chome shares for sure. That's what we're gonna do. Alright, no worries. We'll pull back. We'll bring over like a Doom stack in a second. Well, yeah, we took this village. Do we want to liberate this? Yeah, we're gonna liberate that. Take it away from them. And we can make more infiltrators. Sure, why not? Cool, guys. So we have our little missile turret here. Let's get a military base. This will give us more power when we fight near it. And since we know we're gonna be trying to finish them off. Harkonnen's getting a little bit crunk, though, for sure. Like, I'm starting to see a lot of Harkonnen military presence to the west. Yeah, they're expanding very quickly. So we better hurry up and finish off the Atreides. Because Harkonnens are, they're coming and, they're brutal! You guys remember that scene in the movie? So good. Alright, cool. So you guys can hustle here. And then we can have them run across. This is being liberated, although they've sent some troops, which are going to get their butts kicked by the elite ones I have there. Okay, guys, let's move. Spice fields. Yeah, Harkonnens are... They have any special provinces? Oh, there's one over here. The Moon Dew Valley. This one is Mount Idaho. Oh, that's cool. Is that named after Duncan, Idaho? Cool. Knowledge production, hegemony. Take the hegemony buildings. Who knows, yeah. It adds up. Could get us there a little bit quicker. It's going to be tough to crack their main base, though. But, I mean, that's... Oh, yeah, and we're about to liberate that. The Red Chasm. Actually has pretty high wind strength there. Could take this over. Because we have a bunch of benefits to water production. Okay, so that's been liberated. Let's go take this one over right now. Maybe the spice field will be a little bit more pertinent. Okay, did those guys make it across the desert? All right, hustle it. Let's see if you guys can make it. Let's see if the Fremen have what it takes to get across the mighty desert here. Building slots. Looks like we've taken out the garrison here. Let's take control of this and just get water and get a military base here so we can just completely sandwich them. We don't have that much authority at the moment. Okay, look at that. Man, they run across that desert like it's nobody's business. We're about to get the military threat. This one's pretty cool. It's good if you're playing diplomacy more, but we're going for Desert Command, which gives us 20% unit power per spice collector in the same region. So if you're fighting in regions with spice, your guys are just like super jacked.
We are listening.
It's very, very cool. All right, guys. Progress is progress. Thank you all for joining today. It's been quite a bit of fun. Yeah, treaties are going to be... Well, it's funny because the Atreides have a character that can force treaties. Your opponent can't say no to it. It's really funny. So it's Lady Jessica. You pay 50 influence to... Because I would say Atreides play politics quite a bit. They do it pretty well. All right, so let's get water traps here. Cool. And these elite units, is there anything else we need to take? We're at 12.6 right now, so we're just climbing up there. We'll get some Chome share soon too. We're just going to save up a ton of money. Yeah, we got the reinforcements. I think we can go take down this city. Yeah, Atreides lost their other province. The Harkonnen sausages will pay next. We'll take them out. Because yeah, they're the only other big threat. They're at 10.4, so they're not that far behind me. We are playing on hard this time around, so... Okay, looking good. So we're going to try and take out this base. Unfortunately, we have a missile turret plus the main base here. Atreides might use like a ceasefire. We're going to use a supply drop here because it heals my army passively. Then we're going to develop another supply drop while we do this. Sand cloak. All military units are invisible for 2 days. That's pretty cool. Yeah, this game's new. Yeah, it just came out. Okay, so... Let's liberate it. Can we, like, not get shot at by that giant turret? Okay, so what we do here is we just pull you guys back. And we just leave a stealth unit there. I don't think the big base should be able to see them. Oh, smuggler's getting a little bit crunk up here. I think we have heavy militia plus a turret, so that should be okay. I can't wait to play this in PvP, this game. That's where it's really going to shine. I mean, the AI is like, you know, can only do so much. We can go ahead and get another military base here. So let's get the command points and plus 20% power to all our military.
We will help if we can.
Yeah, and that's all they have. So at this point, like, they won't be able to muster enough units to actually break my garrisons. So we don't care anymore. We don't need to finish them off. Yeah, see, I lost my Arrakis maximum infiltration there. You can put more crew in your spice collectors. I think I can now. Yeah, you're right. I finished that technology. I forgot. Okay, so gonna be getting that spice going.
We are listening.
We've been paying our taxes. We're at 13,000. We could buy a fair amount of win victory points right now. Win more points, yes. Something I haven't been good at doing is grabbing shit on the map. Like, you should get your ornithopters to go explore these sites. Turn off auto recon.
What do you need?
And then they'll, like, you know, find those. And do I have an alliance here? I believe I do. Yeah, this is the upkeep. That's the upkeep in that region. And then you, I don't know. This one's not very good, but we're just going to do it to get the victory points. This one we'll be able to get very, very soon. All right, so we're about to liberate this village from the Atreides, and then all they have is their one base now. So just to be safe, we're gonna wipe the last of their army here to make sure they can't take anything. Like, killing the main base takes like a long time. So we're just gonna wipe their army, and then we don't have to worry about Atreides anymore. Fremen, you pay a bribe, which allows you to buy their silence. So you pay a bribe to the Space Guild, and then you get plus one authority for it. That's like the benefit you get for paying the Spice. You don't have to, though, if you don't want to. But you should, because by paying the taxes, you get victory points. All right, cool. So, yeah, Atreides is pretty much done for, so we're going to head down here now. And, what do we want to build? Water in this region? Not really. Spice, Plascrete, sure, why not? We can always just sell stuff we have in excess. Like, I could go to, you know, Homeboy here.
Let's get to business.
And what does he want? Does he have any interest in this? Let's see. So, 1,000 Plascrete. Let's see how much gold he's going to give me. Yeah, no, not too much, because he cares a lot. So let's go to Baron Chungus. Actually, Atreides, they do like this material, actually. Yeah, so 2,000 gold for 2,000. I'm just going to take his gold and give him Plascrete, which he can't even use. This is the guy we just smashed, and he'll still trade with us, which is pretty funny. I guess in the world of Dune, they're very used to these kind of machinations and schemes. We have another spice field here. It does border the Harkonnen, which is getting a little bit shady. We do want this special site here. So let's just take this spice field first. Oh, it's been ravaged recently. Okay, so we can't get that. So we're going to go fight the Harkonnen now. Smugglers making a comeback? Let's see. Yeah, not really. I mean, they have a fair amount of territory, but I don't think they're a huge threat. I have my thumpers maxed out, so my army can get around pretty quick if need be. Point of interest investigated, so resolve. And resolve. See, like, I should be getting my little chopthopters and going and investigating shit. It's pretty haggard that I haven't been.
As fast as I can.
Alright, so we definitely want this one. Not that we can build a water extractor, but it does give us 1,000 victory points, which is just too good to pass up on. So Harkonnen's gonna lose this shit. Sorry, buddy. The fight is on. The fight is on indeed. Okay, cruising down here. Let's see what schemes are afoot. Harkonnen, it's time to pay the troll toll. The big Chungus, this big chubby man, thought he could get away, but
what do you want?
So creepy looking. Look at him. All right. How old do people live to be in the Dune universe? You guys actually know, like, what the lore is? Like, do they live super long with some sort of technology or something? Alright, very good. So Harkonnen is probably going to respond. I would imagine we're going to get a bunch of troops dropshipping in soon, but we have a big army here. We actually took a little bit of damage there, mind you. Take control. Cool. Okay, where is the Harkonnen response? They have a fair amount of land, but I think we can put a dent in them. Atreides is just sitting in their main base, just like, well, this sucks. So we got water here. Let's get a missile turret. Get some heavy militia. And is this fully developed up here? It is, and it is. Great. Oh, not that long. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. The Fremen may pay the spice tax, but the Harkonnens pay the troll toll. The Circle, man, makes me want to play this game. Dude, you mean the big chubby guy? Yeah, no, he's pretty fun. Vanguards, what are these? Oh, these are the Berserker Harkonnen units, yeah.
Always stay alert.
But, like, all my stealth units?
We are listening.
Watch this. These guys have backstabs, so when they do their first damage, You can like just do a ton of burst damage. Check this out. So if you want to like micro in this game, you can do like little things like this. Oh, like you can do a mass backstab and then run away, and then it like resets. But they actually have a big army here. They have some stealth drones, so I need to make sure to fight together. We're gonna do a supply drop here to heal my units, and then we're gonna fight. Oh yeah. The Fremen have so many stealth units; it can really catch people. Okay, House Guard. These are the elite Harkonnen units. They're pretty strong, but I don't think he wants to fight me. Okay, point of interest investigated. Let's resolve that.
All clear. Receive.
Let's go check this out. Yeah, they're amassing an army on the border here. Siege detected. So I think we already formed an alliance there. There was a couple sieges that we didn't quite iron out yet. I think this one. Cool, so that's all victory points. And you see our whole army healed to full using the supply drop. That's why the Spacing Guild, if you're going to be going for authority play, is so good. Yeah, I'm gonna buy Chome shares. I'm just waiting till I can end the game with it before I buy it. Okay, now I have the gunners coming in. So you can actually do control groups in this game too.
Listen to the sound.
So like we're gonna put these like So it's a skirmisher. Let's get you guys out here, and out here. So there is some, like, micro in this game. Against the AI, it doesn't matter as much, but, like... So I can run my assassins back here, right? And then have my main army right here. So when he comes to fight, I can, like, flank him and backstab him and just kill all those units, right? So there's lots of cool stuff like that. Missile turret, heavy militia. So I'm, like, waiting for them to engage, although I don't think they're going to. No, they're landing more troops. Okay. And let's go ahead and get a gear sabotage. Very good. And let's see what else we can potentially get. Chome shares. Atomics. You can get nukes, too. Shit's friggin' crazy. Okay, here they come. So they're going to come here, and then we're going to flank him with these stock units. And these guys do bonus on their first attack. So you just, like, sneak up behind them, and they do a ton of damage. Okay, Harkonnen's coming in. The big fight of fights. See, I have control groups. I can tab between them, so it's kind of like RTS in that way. So let's creep up behind him now. Let's pull back a little bit. Like, let them think they're nice and cozy. Okay, the militia should pop out. Oh, we didn't get the militia finished in time. Missile turrets here. So let's go get on the shooty units, and then you can jump on these guys, and you can jump on these guys. Okay, here comes the flank. It's so cool. Oh my god, they're getting massacred! Look at the surround! Let's do a supply drop. Make sure our units are healing. Holy shit. That's the desert power right there. So yeah, like, oh, that was a massacre. Oh my god. So the AI thinks, like, the AI couldn't see my infiltrator, so it thinks its army can win, which it would have been able to maybe win if it didn't get flanked like this. But now they're just surrounded and getting circle beaten, although their house guard are fighting pretty well, actually. So, like, in this case, you would want to micro back, like, injured units, and, like, try and get them back and save them. Because those, like, little micro plays actually do matter. Yeah, like, just absolute beatdown. Plus, there was a missile turret there helping me, so. Yeah. Micro does matter in this game a little bit. So, let's get you fully infiltrating Arrakis. Let's go with the Spacing Guild. Yes, let's max them out. The Surround, baby. Yeah, and there are like, there is backstab in this game and yes, all sorts of that kind of stuff. All right, so let's resolve this. What do you need? So, let's see what the smugglers want. What do they want? They like influence and they like intel, neither of which I want to give them. Big Chungus, he just got his butt kicked.
What do you want?
Does he have anything I want? Not really. Okay. We're just killing it on spice as well. They got squeezed there pretty good. Yes, they did. All right, so let's keep building out this region. So we want to get a military base here since we're going to be fighting like nonstop in this area. Did this one get developed? It looks like it did. We have enough authority to take another settlement now, if I'm not mistaken. So we just want to get all these like special settlements. That's where all the good stuff is, my friends. But we could just keep punishing Harkonnen as well. Ooh, another special region. Perfect. What does this one do? Yeah, processing plant. That's really good. Okay. So we're hustling over there.
We are listening.
All right. Perfect. Could take more spice. Feeling pretty good. Points of interest investigated. So let's resolve that. Take some of the money. Just a casual 50,000 gold at this point. Because we're getting gold for every neutral village too. So all these like villages that aren't settled here, I'm getting money for that because of the Fremen tech. Looks like they have some house guard up here guarding this. And let's get in there. And do we want to take this? Yeah, we're taking this village. We're for sure taking that. That's the good stuff right there. We'll buy some Chome shares. We're pretty close to winning, actually. How long have we been streaming for? I think this one's going to be a lot quicker than the Harkonnen one. I was also didn't really know what I was doing with Harkonnen. Though they're mustering pretty elite armies pretty quickly, so they're no slouches. See, and if I was playing with, like, a couple players, like, everyone would be backstabbing. Like, everyone would be ganging up on me, like, sending agents at me and, like, you know, stealing my territories from the side. So when it comes to, like, the other game type, it's going to get really wild. Man, how do they have two missile turrets here? I guess Harkonnen has something for that, maybe? Harkonnen getting the double missile turret. Okay, looks like they got troops coming, too. Okay, so we need to use, ooh, shit. We don't have a supply drop. That's actually kind of poor that I did that. Because a lot of my units are pretty close to death, actually. Okay, let's run you back. Yeah, and the main base is shooting me, I think. Something is. Oh, it's heavy militia. Okay, that's what it is. Okay, they're coming with troops on the border, so let's go ahead and do a gear sabotage here. And now we can take control of this village. We need to get that supply drop up stat. Because Harkonnens are mustering on the border. We're taking back Arrakis, we are, slowly but surely, brother. Atreides is chilling up here. He's just like, okay, I'll just stay on my base, it's fine. What other main infrastructure buildings can I build? So, influence, and this one gives you... Yeah, whatever, let's get this. We have so much dough at the moment. Okay, we almost have the supply drop, which is going to be huge. Uh-oh. Being shot. Yeah, what are they shooting us with? I guess they have a missile launcher over there. Supply drop, come on, come on, come on, come on. Boom. That's going to start healing up all our units. And then we want to do another supply drop. Gear sabotage. Yeah, that's fine. Do we have this base yet? Not quite. Man, it takes forever to... When you're trying to capture like a fully... Okay, and it looks like now there's some raiders heading over. I think our heavy militia plus the missile turret should do the trick. Let's get a hegemony building. The Harkonnens looking like they want a party. So we'll go for another surrounding them. Yeah, I need the... Oh, look, raiders. The raiders are attacking the Harkonnen army. Let's go see if we can get a cheese. No, okay, never mind. They crushed those. Get those raiders too quickly. I do need the donkey, yeah. I think I can build one now. Okay, let's pause for a second. Yeah, I can build the caravans. And then let's just get a huge army. Alright, team. Wow, shit, this is a big fight. Okay, so let's go ahead and do a gear sabotage. That's going to lower their power in this region. We need to get on all the range units. So let's get you on you, you on this. Make sure they don't have that. Great. And now we can do a supply drop here too to continue the healing. So that will give us passive healing, and also a lot of our units are actually getting their butts kicked though, man. Okay, let's pull you back. Infiltrators getting beaten down over here pretty badly. We don't have that many elite units, and they have a lot of house guard here. I think we lose this fight. Maybe. That missile turret's killing us, Smalls. Could withdraw, but regardless, we could build a new army up pretty quick, I think. Maybe we just barely win this. I think the elite units we have, the Fidakins, are just gonna carry this. Okay, wow, we actually won it. A little bit of lag coming through from those missile turrets over there. That missile turret from the other base is really giving us a lot of grief. Okay, let's get some infiltrators and cool. We'll bring the reinforcements over.
Summon the sandworm.
Okay, we almost have enough to just, like, straight up win the game. Off the hegemony. Stop shooting me! Okay, we need more supply drops and gear sabotage. The Harkonnens getting double missile turrets definitely makes it a pain. Okay. So we have the caravans. Can set up and help hide your troops. So set up a camp. Okay, so then it hides your army. That's pretty rad. Okay, so we'll try this right now. Are we fully developed up here, by the way? No. Shit, we've been really bad about doing that. We've been here for ages. Just not doing anything. Okay, down there, down there. Got this. How are we looking in the middle? And don't care for influence. Manpower is actually pretty low right now. Yeah, we need to get manpower. Development research. Okay, so we got the Desert High Command. We pretty much have all the goodies in terms of military. Yeah, let's get the harvesting team gather rate per allied siege. So we're just going to have like a million spice.
Bless the maker and
all right, so let's gather you guys and just bring the reinforcements over. We have the double caravan, so... The hell is this? Really? The Harkonnens coming in? Oh, it's because they can't see the invisible units, so the AI keeps getting tricked. It's pretty funny how that works. Okay, where are you at?
We trust you, Liet.
All right, so let's get the sandworm to cruise over. He can't make it all the way over. He can make it pretty far, so let's just do the sandworm right there.
The desert will surprise you.
All right, so the reinforcements will be here soon. I don't know in the Dune universe. I guess in the movies, at least. I can't remember in the books if, like, vehicles. I know the, like, ornithopters and the flying, the little, they have, like, planes and stuff, but, don't you try it, smugglers. Don't you try that shit, I swear. Yeah, Harkonnen's actually putting up a fight, though. I can't just bully through them like I could with the Atreides. Atreides are went down pretty quick. Okay, so we need more manpower buildings because we can't quite sustain our business here. Okay, the sandworm dropped off the reinforcements. Let's hustle them across. Man, yeah, look at this. Our Conans are coming with a bunch of elite units again. Let's get on the range units back here. Yeah, I got reinforcements coming across. The Donkeys of Doom are on their way too, with two more elite units to get the Dakins as well. Alright, let's pull back our infiltrators. Let them reset their stealth and get the backstab again. Looks like they're running, yeah, the missile turrets. Oh, because we inherited both of their missile turrets. Even though like Fremen can't build the double turret, that's pretty funny. But they had built it and we took it over, so... Oh, there's a military base here too. Oh, it's brutal. Holy shit. Okay.
We trust you, Liet.
Ouch, dude. Ouch. Major beatdowns. And we get hegemony from taking out those units too.
We trust you, Liet.
All right. So, where do we have building slots? It gets a little bit trickier when your empire gets so vast. Manpower, yes, please. And you're done. You're done. I believe here we are maxed out too. We got manpower going there. I'm trying to think of other special regions. I think this is one of the last ones here. So we got military base, a craft workshop, Solari production, I mean, and double missile battery. That's actually pretty sweet. Oh, you can get double turret with the right tech. I always thought that was a Harkonnen thing. Thank you. Thank you for correcting me, brother. Where do we go now? Hey, Trollios, thank you for the $10 donation. Greatly appreciate it. I missed that one 16 minutes ago, but there was no message, but thank you. Greatly appreciate it, my friend. Okay, so let's see what we have here. Another building slot. We have enough authority to take over a base now, so we can definitely push down. I'm trying to think how we want to deal with the Harkonnens. Okay, so we actually have a lot of influence now for some godforsaken reason. So the elected faction gains authority production, so yes, let's just put all our votes in there. Yeah, why not? See if I can do that. Like, you can still participate, but you just have to play a different style. There are definitely some kind of armored fighting vehicles in later in the series, but he doesn't care about describing them at all. Got it.
We trust you.
Yeah, okay, there is another, the Observatory Mountain here. We want that. So we're going to liberate this village to get the gold, and then we're going to push up and just do that. Let's just sell all our spice and get mega greedy right now. Okay, let's take out the Harkonnen garrison with our missile turrets. A little bit of damage coming. It's pretty cool if Fremen can get these caravans, for sure. Man, these heavy militia are just meaty, man. I should probably, like, turn the speed down so I can actually map. Micro a little bit. It's got to pull back the injured units if you can. The missile turrets just add so much more DACA to the enemy build. See, the thing is, with other factions, you can reinforce really easily, but every time you want to reinforce with a single unit with Fremen, you have to use a sandworm charge, which are very sparse. So, like... Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay. I'm sorry, Mr. Sandworm. We can be friends. Let's go ahead and liberate this. Yep, liberate it. And we have our wagon here, so this is going to be... Yeah, look, our supplies are maxed out, so those little caravans to help and hide nearby troops. Looks like they're coming in for more. A little trickle down right there. Oh, God. Don't come this way, please. Just let me take this village, for the love of the gods. Looks like there was something going... Oh, they sabotaged my gear. Okay, interesting. Okay, looks like the storm is moving southwards. I've never tried one of these, like, caravan things. Let's see what happens. Okay. Does it crash my game? No. Oh, okay. So we get this camp. Okay, let's see what's happening here. Supply per day and health regeneration per day. That's really cool. So, like, when you're on the road, you can set up camps even in, like, the middle of nowhere. Yeah, you use the sandworm to carry you across. Raiders heading up to my settlement here, but missile turret plus heavy militia should deal with that.
Ericus belonged.
Once we get 20,000 hegemony, we're going to be able to win, because we can just buy Chome shares, I think. We'll start doing it now. I think it takes time, so we'll start doing that. It costs 10,000 per, but we have so much.
What
so.
Do you need?
Okay, they're attacking the smugglers, which is good.
What do you need?
We're going.
Are we looking fully developed here? Then we just go take over the special region, which this one gives plascrete. Okay, that's pretty nice. Granted, we don't really want for any resources anymore. But it's more like the late game, the final hour. And we're liberating this, so it's going to delete all of the Harkonnen buildings, so even if they recapture it, like sometimes if you're in really, really far away, so let's break camp. Man, huge lag spike when you activate those, though. But when you're far away from your base, if you're playing versus like friends when PvP gets added, for example, you might want to just liberate their bases to delete all of their tech and just like punish them. And with Fremen, you also get money for that, so. Man, Harkonnens are just coming in for round two here. They're about to lose this fat base, though. Holy shit, oh my god. That's gonna be a big fight. Okay. Well, this is gonna get liberated. Alright, that's fine. You guys can try and defend this now. Let's actually go fight them here. And use a gear sabotage. Although, they're split into two regions. Yeah, oh, stealth drones. Wow, that is a big Harkonnen army. That's the biggest one I think we've actually seen. Alright, let's get back and fight them on our terms. I don't know where they're going to go. Maybe over here. Yeah, because stealth drones, they when they die, it buffs the whole Harkonnen army. And he's got a bunch of those, so let's follow them here. Okay, looks fine. We took that region down. Yeah, we have this region. Looking good. Okay, they're gathering on this border here. Do they have a military base here? They don't. They have an airfield coming up, though. Alright, so let's do this. And now we can go ahead and do... oh shit, we don't have the gear sabotage. That's the Chome chairs. Gonna pop that right now. Alright, so we're battling. They're in range of missile turrets. Defeat them, Fremen! Dude, our elite units just cut through them so quick, man. It's awesome. Yeah, we caught them. We definitely caught them a little bit unaware there. I think a lot of their stuff was out of position. Let's see if we can get this guy. Oh look, the caravans actually shoot. That's pretty cool. So they fight. Okay, let's pull in here. And now we can start on the Chome shares again. So this is like, we just spend money to get like the victory points. You want to come? You want some of this? Desert power, baby. All right, let's grab this. Cool. So we'll clean up this. I'm gonna lose you. Hopefully not. Let's see if we can get you back. Ah, retreat. A little bit sloppy there. Let's get another big boy. He can just run across. The elite units certainly are doing pretty well. Alright, almost got it. Almost got it. Dude, those heavy militia take forever to kill. Are we under attack anywhere? No, combat, ongoing siege. Okay, so this one we definitely want to take control of. Alright, let's pause. What do the Chome shares actually cause? And then we want to do... I don't know if we have enough mission intelligence here. Shit. Our army's pretty healthy still, I guess. Alright, here we go. Round two. I like that the AI here is actually putting up a bit of a fight. Let's get this warrior back. He can run back north to this base and heal. We don't want to lose anything, but yeah, they're still getting their butts kicked. In my experience, the Fremen military units are really strong. Yeah, taking down the house guard there. They got some stealth drones on their way over. Cool. Got to monitor the health of all of our different units, make sure nobody's getting karate chopped. Rebellion underway. Okay, so somebody started a rebellion in my land, so it's pretty annoying. We might have to sandworm a couple units over to go deal with that. And we can go ahead and build another one. Yeah, we got him in melee here. We need to take this over, though. This is going to give us a lot of victory points. Get in there in melee, try and shut those guys down. I'm going to set up a camp here to see if it actually heals me while I'm fighting. I don't think it does, but if they do, that would be very, very strong. Okay, the House Harkonnen guardsmen are being cut up. And I believe this warrior is chilling. Once we get a couple, we can deal with that rebellion. I really don't want to lose this base. Although it's not even super well developed, but I think it is a special region. It's one of our main water regions, actually. We do need that. So let's get you back. And get you back. I think our elite units can hold on to this. Okay, team. Do we have you as an ally? We gotta make sure we have alliances with all those guys soon.
We'll avoid the sun.
Supply drop, let's do it.
Lead us to freedom.
So these three are gonna go deal with the rebellion. They're gonna use one of the thumpers to get over there.
No drop will be spilled.
Okay.
What does Liet command?
The sandworm can only be called on sand. Oh, that makes sense.
We're going.
Not on ice. Oh man, the rebellion's like pretty close to getting it over there. What does this rebellion look like? It's mainly just shitty rebels. I honestly think we could probably send one guy.
This path is dry.
You guys are almost on the sand anyways. That'll be a little bit quicker. Looks like we're capturing this. The supply drop has healed us. And let's get the thumper. And take the sandworm to go squash the rebellion if we can. Although, man, it gets us like really close, but not quite there. We might have to rebuild that province. Like, other factions would get there quicker with air. Fremen still have some limitations. Even though the sandworm is pretty cool, it's like, they're gonna get this for sure. We're gonna have to get that back, and maybe we're gonna have a water deficit as well. Which is unfortunate. Alright, and you guys can move here.
We trust you, Liet.
Come on. Are we gonna get there in time? No, sandworm's still a little ways away. Damn! We're so close to winning, too. We're at 215. How much does the Chome Chairs one actually cost? Only 50, actually, so we can just keep doing that. Try and win that way. Recon, points of interest, owned villages, militia. I mean, honestly, we could just start going down this tree. We're kind of... Our knowledge is so good that we can just almost hit everything, which is really, really strong in the late game. A couple Harkonnen units coming to try and pay the troll toll. Yeah, we did lose that water region, which is unfortunate. So let's go get that back if we can. Ah, it was recently attacked, so we can't. That's a shame. Ah, we can take this one, I guess. The wind here is okay. And the worm guys, they can run across to us. We've taken over this base, so we have the influence structure, which we can delete. We have the hegemony, the knowledge, and the plascrete. Pretty decent set of buildings here, but we definitely want to get a missile turret and a military base to fend off the Harkonnens, who just keep going ham here. Get our own heavy militia to buffer this army out. Okay, maybe it looks like they're trying to do something here. Occupy that. Very close to winning. Very, very close. Okay, so let's have you scout here. I should be doing that more often, man. So that's good. Let's get a military base. Yeah, Harkonnens are coming, but they're going to be meeting my militia soon, too. The heavy militia plus the missile turrets will really wreck them. And, oh, all my units are hidden right now. Oh, so they can't see them because of the camp I set up. That's cool. So then you just pop out and give them the dirty. Oh, that's really rad. Yeah, look at them trying to flee. That's wild. Alright, so let's get some water traps, because we need to make sure we have water for our people. Points of interest investigated, let's resolve that. Okay, spying logistics gives us more agents. I don't know, yeah, I guess we just do defense systems. Hey, Cyrus! Is this the new Total War? No, I'm not going to play this as much as Total War, because the replayability of this game, it's going to be really fun to play each faction once, but once you play each faction once or twice, I think... You need multiplayer from there. And multiplayer is coming soon, hopefully, according to the developers. Is there any? Okay, so let's buddy up with all these sieges here. Start trading with this one. And the Chome shares are done. So we need to do that again. And Chome shares. Cool. Because, yeah, after I've beaten the game once with, like, all the factions, I like, what I'm looking forward to is, like, the political machinations of you know, an FFA game, basically. The camp thing is really cool for the Fremen. I really like that feature. That's really cool. Our water's really tight right now, unfortunately. Yeah, those guys do some work. Very close to winning. Very, very close. 22.4 at the moment. Now I have the hiccups. Oh god. Not like this. And I had some dudes I think I sent over here. They can scurry across the desert. Harkonnens are preparing an offensive here. I think we have heavy militia and double missile turrets. That's actually going to be very durable, so. Let's kind of sit on the wing here. And see what's cracking. Chome share is successful. So we'll do that again. And then we can just kind of keep doing that and just spending all our money on these shares, which are giving us victory points. We could do nukes too. Yeah, look at the double missile turret, man. That's so much damage. Combat ongoing, yes. The heavy militia popped out and we got our army heading over to help, so we should be able to easily dispatch this force. And these big boys are gonna run over here as well. Yeah, absolute beatdown, especially with the heavy militia. Our poor little camper needs to run away though. Don't wanna get those guys caught. Village under siege, operation against me, nice, I love it. All right guys, only need a little bit more. I think we can just straight up buy our way to victory here with the chum shares. So what happens when you own all the spice, you just get rich. Because guys, like, I'm selling so much spice right now. Like, I have so many stockpiles. It's just ridiculous. Like, all right, let's go beat these guys down. Yeah, my Fidakins have 1,000 HP and the House Guard have 780. Their power is, let's see what my power is. My power is 38. Like, my guys beat the brakes off their guys in terms of elite units. Just liberate all the Harkonnen territory. That's the plan. That's definitely the plan. Yeah, we lost some heavy militia here to the Harkonnen attack. The missile turret's picking off their fleeing units. Yeah, man. Pretty solid playthrough today. I feel like everything went pretty smooth. We can actually kill these damn turrets too. And how are we doing on infiltration? Do we want to get like a supply drop? Yeah, I think we're okay. I've been wanting to try the nukes to see what that's like too. Oh, it's a skirmisher, okay. Yeah, so getting through the demolition. Harkonnens are just back fleeing the scene. Dude, look at the score. 24.2 to 15k is the next closest, jeez. And this was on hard. I actually was considering doing easy today. But there is one more difficulty setting above this, which is very hard. And I think it's like Total War in that they cheat. Let's go ahead and liberate this. So with Fremen, you don't really want to pillage. Oh god. We don't want to feed Shai-Hulud to our own people here, so. Victory for the Fremen. The visionary rebel. We did it. We are the true leaders of Arrakis. They have recognized us. So that was pretty fun. Yeah, man. I mean, they seem really strong. Like, playing the land as Fremen seems like the way to go. Like, espionage, I guess, could be okay, but just using the authority from these two characters that you have, because we have the spice field authority guy who gives us authority for every spice field, and then Grandma reveals all the spice fields. So it's like, you can just grow so quickly. Yeah. So the only one, I've done Atreides. Atreides is pretty interesting. What you do is, I think Atreides play politics really well. You get Lady Jessica and you force agreements on people, which is pretty cool for getting a lot of money. And yeah, you can play agents with Thufir Hawat, all kinds of cool stuff you do. Yeah. Peaceful annexation lets you spend, you can basically take over villages without having to attack them, and you can do it anywhere on the map. So if like you see a village that's open, you can just grab it using peaceful annexation and it slowly becomes yours. It slowly becomes yours, which is really cool. So I haven't played, I played Atreides on my own time, so next time we do a stream, if you guys are still interested, of course, I would do a smuggler one, but smugglers I'd probably do it on very hard, because I think that wasn't hard enough. So we would go up to very hard, or insane, because I think that would be too easy there. So they can install underground headquarters in opponents' villages, can place bounty on Lanzarad resolutions, improved interactions with Arrakis black markets. Okay. It seems like fun. You gain 50 votes at the Lanzarad. Okay, so you actually have a little bit of a say in the Lanzarad there. And they get free mercenary units. Mercenaries are really good. They build in like 5 seconds. Could be pretty fun. Do you think this is a feature? No, I think they're going to add more. They'll probably add like DLC factions, I would wager. I don't even know who they would really add though, I guess. Like maybe they could add a Saudakar, or like the Emperor has like, you could play as the Emperor somehow and like have like some overarching presence on it. I don't know. Smugglers make some mad bank. Yeah, I think so. There are some yeah, exactly. There's different win conditions too, because like, I won with hegemony. You can win with domination. You can win with domination, hegemony, or political. A political victory is also possible because you become the governor of Dune. So let me show you guys real quick. Hold up. Let's resume, whatever. It'll take us into the game. GG! So, okay, we're back in the game that we just won. And yeah, like right before we won. You can win by getting all the charters. So Harkonnens had two of the four main charters. And then if you are, if you get elected as the governor right here through politics and you stay as the governor for 60 days, you just straight up win the game, right? So you can do like a political victory. This is how I won with Atreides. When I was playing Atreides, I did Dune. I became the governor of Dune and I held it for 60 days and I won. So in order to do this, you need to control a certain amount of Arrakis regions. You need to be allies with at least four sieges, and then you have to be elected. You can see the prerequisites down there as well. So each of these have like different requirements. Like to be the leader of the Water Sellers Union, you have to control the polar sink in the middle and have a ton of water production, right? So these all kind of help you to get there. Domination is just killing enemy bases, which I did on my first stream. With Harkonnens, I killed all the bases. This time we went with a hegemony victory, just based on playing spice and playing the land. And of course you have victory conditions through espionage and whatnot. So like, over here, you would just like get all the technology. Like you get spying logistics, your agents produce 100% faster. You get countermeasures 100% faster. So you're getting agents 200% faster than everyone. And with even more tech, you get more agents. You can have like, so at this point in the game, I didn't do anything with agents really. And I have 7. If I was playing a political espionage type build, I would probably have like 3 times, 4 times as many. Like I would have everything filled up. And I could be doing crazy missions. I could be trying to assassinate faction leaders. Yeah, Governor of Dune is like building a wonder, for sure. That's relatively similar indeed. But yeah, DLC factions could be House Ix, House Ordos, House Carino. And yeah, I mean, sounds good. I would love to see some of that. I would love to see some of it. And hopefully they'll do it. I mean, I think the game's really fun. I think it's going to really shine in multiplayer. Like, when I play multiplayer, I think what I'm going to do, I mean, Fremen, I think, would be the easiest. So if there's somebody playing with me who's, like, really new, I would probably put them on Fremen and just say, like, just go eco and play spice, and you're going to be fine. But I would probably want to do Harkonnen and do, like, a political build. So you can use Fade. So he will give corruption on Lanzarad resolutions. So you can, like, let people win the Lanzarad resolutions, and then you can corrupt them so they lose standing. It's really funny. So there's all kinds of stuff you can do. Yeah, probably a big chungus political build. Although, honestly, Atreides is really good for politics because of Lady Jessica. You can spend influence to force treaties, which is crazy, crazy good. Because you could just be like, oh, how about a non-aggression pact? And they're like, no, I want to fight you. And you're like, boom, non-aggression pact. And then they just like can't mess with you for a short period of time, right? Yeah, so there's all kinds of good stuff. Feel there's enough reference. Yeah, Governor of Dune is like building wonder, 100%. All right, guys, so that's going to be it for today. Hopefully you enjoyed the stream. I had an absolute blast with you guys. If you enjoyed this, please do drop a like. Let me know if you guys want to see more Dune or not. And regardless, I'll probably do at least one more playthrough of Dune on the channel. A Dune stream before we actually do the multiplayer. Because then I'm just going to wait for multiplayer. Because at that point, you know, I've kind of shown you guys everything. And we've kind of conquered the game as it is, which, you know, so far I think I've already played like 20 hours plus or so. Let's see, how many hours have I played? Yeah, 20 hours. So certainly I've gotten my bang for my buck for the price of the game, and I enjoy it. I think it's worth playing. All right, guys. Thank you. We'll see you next time. Take care of yourselves. Good times to come. Tomorrow, I might have to be out of town tomorrow, so it might just be a video going up. But regardless, there'll be something tomorrow. And then on Thursday, we're going to have a Total War tournament, which I'm going to schedule right now on TotalTavern.com. And then on Friday, we're hosting an Age of Empires FFA tournament. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of fun. Any multiplayer game where you can stab your friends in the back while shaking their hand is great. 100%. And that's why I think this is going to have pretty good potential for that. All right, my friends. Appreciate you all. See you soon. Take care of yourselves. And the Desert Power is victorious today. Yes.